sure we'll be keeping an eye on some of these players. Let's start with West Perth and how they line up today.
Yeah, absolutely. We've got some big names in there. We mentioned Kane Bevan. Another one, Griff Julian. He's got a state combine. The recruiters will be looking at him today, as well as Kane Bevan. And in the key forward position, Noah Farrow. He kicked 3 goals the last time these guys played and was probably the difference in that game. They've got some great defenders in Dan Gathercole, Luke Michael, who's a rock down there. So they're going to have to penetrate them, Peel, if they're going to get some score on the board.
Yes, they dominated the WAFL Colts team of the year. What about the Thunder? We know with Tregenza in attack, they're going to be finding a big target more often than not. Good conditions early for him at least.
No, absolutely. I expect him to have a big game today. They've got a young Mitch Edwards in the ruck. He's going to be a good player for them. Ethan Donaghy in the mid. So good contest we're looking for.
West Perth, Peel Thunder, the formalities about to begin. Let's head downstairs for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the national anthem?
Australians are led.
It's grand final day here at Leaderville. The sun's out, the Colts are out. Stay with us. The first set of bouts only moments away for the 2022 Colts grand final.
Which will only get busier as the course of the day winds on. Xavier Ellis joining us upstairs, and yes, you can tell it's been a quick flight up the stairs.
There's no elevators here, Skeet, unlike Optus, mate. That was a good skip up the stairs. Well done to you, but what a great day for footy. I love watching the Colts.
Here we go. Colts action grand final underway, and a ruckman halve the contest. West Perth will win the first clearance up towards half forward. Ball hits a deck in dispute. Now, emerging with it was Nelson. Beautiful kick, hits his target, and that is a way to start. And you mentioned Noah Farrow, Adam Jones, in the pregame. He gets a touch early.
Yeah, it'll be fantastic for his confidence. And he's not a good defender. Tristan Bryce, he was in the Colts team of the year, but he's got a big job today to keep Noah quiet, because if he kicks a bag, it could well be the difference.
Farrow on the runway. Kick 3 last time they met. He's bagged his first inside the opening 60 seconds.
And it started in the midfield there, which is going to be a key for Peel to get on top of their big, strong mids, and got it out. Nice, easy chest mark for Noah Farrow. Might have to look at playing in front of him, Tristan, because he's going to be a big target for them all day.
This is the contest we're looking forward to. Edwards from Peel against Sprigg in the ruck. Second look at each other. Good bounce. Edwards gets hands to it, but it's sharked by Julian. And another inside 50 ball coming up here for West Perth. And another mark is a strong use of the body by Marafiotti. Not intent on going long. Wants to hit up the target. And guess what? He's found his forward again. And Farrow could have 2 in the blink of an eye.
And another chest mark. Yeah, he's going to have to change up his strategy pretty quick, I think, there, Chris and Bryce.
Well, here it is. Change it up both ways, too. In it comes on the chest, traditional full forward play. Might have to get the hands out too at some stage as well, but good play early.
Farrow, 30 out for the dream start. Couldn't write the script any better if you're a Colts fan of West Perth.
What we saw was a carbon copy clearance there for West Perth. Danny Charters and the Peel coach is going to have to do something about that, as well as the headache of Noah Farrow up forward.
Well, these clearances too, out of the middle. It's been a handball back and a quick kick, and it's worked twice by playing in front. Looking as we speak now, West Perth in front in the forward line again.
Bear in mind, both these sides finished the home and away season. 12 wins, 4 losses. Edwards with a good tap. Donaghy took a long time to dispose of the footy. Helping him out in the end was Chewia. Back towards the 50 for Peel. Their first entry almost. Came behind the back of Draper. West Perth feed it out. Too slick for Lonnie. Might have caught one high or a sling tackle. It's going to be a West Perth ball coming back.
Clearly a free kick. Too high there against Draper, I think it was. Just the sharp elbow over the back of the head.
Lonnie to the wing. Ghosting across with a acrobatic launch with Sprigg. Tracking it inside defensive 50 is Dravitsky. He's got support in the form of Bryce. Steps back inside. Dravitsky is used. They've got a couple of Peel numbers, and Edwards comfortably takes it at the D50.
Big Mitch Edwards, he's a Fremantle NGA product for next year. 205 centimetres. He looks like a very high pick next year's draft.
Tim English-ish?
Yes, Tim English-like, yep.
Peel just trying to work the ball forward. Tackle laid on it. Martelli was good. Just going back to Mitch Edwards, Clay Hall and Ethan Logan. They missed out on playing in a AFL Futures match as a curtain raiser.
To the AFL Grand Final last week. It was a big decision by the boys, but they decided to pass up that opportunity to help their team get into a Grand Final, and I'm so happy for them that they made that decision and then won last week, and it's all paid off, so hopefully they can have a successful day today.
High contact. Edwards gives it off straight away to the man in question, of one of three in question in Hall, up to the 50. All the Falcons at the spill, taken by Gathercole. Peel just looking as if they've settled in the last minute or two, but West Perth again get the clearance from half back to Marcy, and a boundary line looms in front of what will be a packed bank as we get closer to league bounce down.
Jonesy, just back to that decision pre-AFL Grand Final game. Did the young lads make that call, or was it involved with the footy clubs? How was the decision derived?
They made the call themselves. We offered them some support in terms of, you know, the pros and cons of it, and they were actually going to go. They were going to go play in the game, but after they lost their second final against West Perth, they changed their mind.
Yep.
So West Perth up to the wing. Marafiotti couldn't quite control it. Dravitsky jams it on the boot. Promising build-up now. Chewy has been involved in a couple of passages of play. Maybe a eye contact mark. What is it? It's a free kick.
It's paid the mark.
Take your pick. It's going to be the big man, Tregenza. The range, questionable. He realises that, but loads up in any case. To the goal square. Sits on its end. Tackle was good on Wybird. Ball jars free. Lonnie with a scrambling kick. Still in the field of play. A snap around the body. Coming around. Has he done enough? Well, his teammate in Finch certainly thought so, but there was not a lot of animation on that occasion from Torrent. And so the celebrations were premature.
Well, Tyrant had the inside pass available to Finch, and he opted to have the shot at goal, but maybe next time, as West Perth come out of defence there, maybe next time the short 15-metre pass inside might be the winner.
Skender lays it off immediately. So West Perth intent on going corridor. Terrific kick through the middle. And Datto has the footy. The run and carry of the Falcons has been outstanding thus far. Hand pass out wide from Alexander. Peel working desperately in defence. Rush tries to shut down his opponent. Now back into the hands of DeManley. He spots a target in DeMassey. Hard up against the boundary. He's got a short option. Wasn't a great kick, really. An easy fist away by Bryce. Still a live ball, though. A snap around the body from Datto, and it's going to go across the face.
Datto, one of their country prospects from Muckambooden.
Oh, beautiful.
Mark Seavey territory.
Ah, lovely. I might need more detail than that, too. It's great to see the country kids, man. Give them the opportunity, too, to align themselves with a WAFL club.
Boundary throw-in. Edwards, opposed to Hiscock. And it is 2 goals to a behind, but you feel that Peel have just steadied slightly.
They have steadied slightly, but I wouldn't want to be opening up the defence too quickly. They've charged out of there a couple of times now.
Close to the boundary. Leaving it behind was Carboni. A scramble inside the 50. Griffith Julian, who picked up 27 disposals against Peel in the second semi-final. Averages 23 touches a game this year. One of the key contributors.
Him and Bevan have done some great work together.
Clearing kick from that stoppage by Clark. Bit of fortune there, but Roberts playing in front. Dishes off. Donaghy. Up to the wing. Wybird. Needs a give inside. He does with a hand pass. Too much on it. Oh, clever kick on by Carboni. Must have sensed the danger. Up towards right half forward. Draper tracking it back. We'll have some company in Martelli. And West Perth able to clear. Sweeping hand pass was good by Garraway. And West Perth able to just check and get it down the line. Here's Hiscock.
Bit going on behind play too. Bit of push and shove after that. Ball going forward.
Hiscock. A couple of pair of hands. Well gathered at the spill by Damati. Frenetic footy. Peel work it out defensively. Logan down the line. Good ball.
Lovely kick. Lovely kick. Take a bit of pressure out of it now. Got the long option one-on-one down the line if you need.
Roberts with the sunscreen. Loads up. Heads in the Tregenza direction. He couldn't take the mark. Ball flick forward for Peel. Draper, who's been industrious. And some good numbers through the middle here. And Demandlik has the footy. Short option. Wasn't a great kick, though, for Sprigg. The 19-year-old really had to stretch, but they've got support behind the ball. And Lonnie will gather eventually and give. Short kick over the top. Giancelli. Inside 50. Not great. Delivery, Thompson first back to it, but he got some support, including Selwood. Bounces it. Half back. Good use of the body. Got rid of Giancelli. And now Peel work it. A short ball to Wybird.
The Peel defence looks to have settled a little bit more. They're not as able to rebound the ball quite effectively. It's just that connection with their forwards now.
Moritz, clever use of the body. Got rid of his opponent. And Broadbent. He's one of their key forwards, but great day for Mark Taken, but perhaps a little fatiguing with the way this game is being played thus far. Good chase down tackle, no reward for the effort. The Peel do win it back. Rush. Inboard ball is a good one.
Big switch.
Yeah, the switch is on. Chewy up.
Kicks it well too.
He's averaged 20 touches a game this year. Wybird's started brightly. Not a bad ball. Has an opportunity for Finch. There's the Ginnivan look-alike. The hand pass not great for Tregenza. He gets boot to ball, not quite. Might have been Broadbent deep in attack. They're still scrapping for it in the goal square. Finch lurking, couldn't quite. Hand pass by Lonnie comes out. And a kick down the line. Should be advantageous. DeFaro has come a long way up the ground, but a couple of goals next to his name and then jams it on the boot. Up to the wing. Clever use of the body. Like this young player, Michael Selwood.
He did that well, didn't he? And I like that the umpires didn't call hands in the back. It was just good strength, held his position, and nudged his player under it.
Up towards half forward. Ball on the deck. Farrow doing it all. Ooh, how was that team? No play on was the call. There's the full 360. Trouble also for Hall. He wasn't penalised, so the umpires just showing some latitude. That might be,
has to be
deliberate, surely. No. Ooh. Lucky. It would have been done in the AFL.
Now, I haven't seen a lot of Colts football, Jonesy, this year, but the pace they're going at in 28-degree weather...
Not sustainable.
I dare say the legs might be a little bit heavy in about half-time.
Oh, there's going to be some cramp later in the game, I suspect. There's a minute break after each goal as well, so the quarters are going to go for longer today, so they're not going to be used to that as well.
Good tackle by Chewy. Let's just recap the slight change in the quarter times in the grand final.
Yeah, so once a goal scored, there'll be a minute break to allow the ball to come back to the centre, and then they'll restart the time after a minute.
Where traditionally it's just 25 minutes flat.
That's right.
25 minutes flat, but then the 1 minute break after a goal to allow for obviously the TV and everything to catch up.
So if we have 10 goals in a quarter, that's a 35-minute quarter for the boys.
We had 2 in 2 minutes, but it's dried up since then. Almost 13 into this Colts grand final. Great to have your company. A double decider on 7 Sport. It's already been a Subiaco triumph in the reserves. West Perth and Peel, and then, of course, the Falcons and the Tigers coming your way. Finch dropped the footy. Did he have it? Not sure. Umpire let them go. Taken by Bevan, the captain. Up towards half forward. Alexander halved the contest. Getting a boot to ball was Hiscock, was enough. Body on body. Tackle laid by Rance was good enough. And Peel have just stemmed the flow. They haven't been able to hit the scoreboard themselves yet, though.
And Kane Bevan is the star, Jonesy. Then there's no tags today in Colts footy, so it's enjoy your day.
Pretty much, you can sort of, you know, obviously pay attention to an opponent, but yeah, no tagging at Colts level.
Taylor, this is a touch ball as a result. Good body use by Dravitsky. Won it out, support from Roberts. And a clearing kick.
Good mark.
Out of sight. Came back towards the middle now. Finch, oh, dropped the mark before he'd actually had it. Hand pass behind his teammate Coboni. Back to Finch. He fumbles again. In fact, he's stripped of the footy. It's been a forgettable couple of moments for the young man. And Farrow, who is roaming far and wide.
Yeah, missed opportunity there. If he just had to put the ball out in front of Carboni, he might have had a shot on goal.
Good contest, half forward. Nelson fought the good fight. Call up.
You're right, though. It has steadied. And Peel, we absolutely spewing that they let those two goals through in the first 2 minutes because the balance has been pretty similar after those first 2.5 minutes.
Well, not too dissimilar, even though it was at the gun. That's a throw at the
that
back.
Throw.
Umpire completely missed that one. Julian around his body. Chest mark, not quite. Almost similar to that second semi-final. I might touch on that in a second. Jonesy is a kick by Waring out of defence. Back to a neutral ball. Caught behind was Draper for the Thunder. Inside 50. Mark not taken. Quick kick towards the goal square. And unable to get the right bounce was Chewier. It'll be a throw-in. So bear in mind, at half-time in that second semi-final, West Perth led by 21.
And Peel had not kicked a goal at that point. So it wasn't until the third quarter where Peel opened their account with the goals. But when they did, they kept coming.
West Perth pretty comfortably getting the ball out of defence. Getting to the front was Torrent to bring the ball to ground. Excellent hands by Gianchole. Ball on the deck. Peel gather. Selwood in trouble. And the ball up is called for.
Tristan Bryce with the spoil there on Noah Farrow, trying to get even the ledger a little bit.
Sprig and Broadbent, shoulder to shoulder here. Goes wide of the congestion. Tackle was sound on Sherwood. All spills free. West Perth now back to the middle. Bit of a speculative kick. Might end up well, although Selwood really scrapping hard. Peel looking a bit vulnerable here. There's some numbers behind the ball. Losing it in the tackle. West Perth get it back. Off a step. Lonnie towards full forward. Off hands. Taken by Thompson. And the Thunder able to find a way out onto the chest of Clark.
Good composure coming out. Just take the 15-metre pass and then you can get it going off the back of that. Run and carry here.
Tomasi. And Roberts. Kick was poor. Easily chopped off by Moritz.
Had space over the back there. The congestion was 30 metres in front of him. His turnover again.
Here's another big turnover. And Broadbent. His hand pass wasn't terrific for Draper. Now support from Carboni. Kick again. Not great. Outside 50. And to the advantage of Luke Michael, who scoops it out the back. Taylor in support. Kick almost to the 50. Trying to spoil the footy was Thompson. He still goes at ground level. It's held up and a ball up. I think you're spot on here. The fatigue factor might strike a lot earlier than three-quarter time.
No, good luck, boys. You're still another 3.5 quarters. Just on that one there, Thompson. Tried to sort of half mark it. I reckon when you're out of position there, just send the fist through it. Send it 10 metres and then get after it as opposed to a soft drop like we saw.
Broadbent decisively. And some run and carry here. For Demasi.
Yeah, this is where they need the connection.
Kick is just shallow as well. They've done that 4 or 5 times already. It allows Gianchelli to gather and kick, and Alexander dropped what he may have taken. Selwood puts it, if not out on the full. No, he's done well, Donaghy.
He gets up quickly. Peel got one over the back. Give it the full leg.
Comes through the middle. It's not a bad kick, though. Stretch either. The kick wasn't rightly intended for Hall. And so, once again, the turnover occurs, but losing the handle was Moritz. Was there high contact? Yes, there was. But, gee, there have been some turnovers in this first 10, 15 minutes.
I just think on a hot day, and it's a grand final, take the long option. Don't worry about the short pass.
Like has been done here. Inside 50. And Tregenza never really looked like it. And just rolling through for a rush behind is Jai Skender.
The combination of nerves and heat is absolutely playing a part in this game already, and you can imagine the heat's only going to get a bit worse for the boys.
Absolutely, and every grand final's messy. I don't care what anyone says. At all levels, they're messy because of the extra excitement and energy and all that. So if you're going to make a mistake, make the long mistake and not the short one.
Waring, defensive hand pass, Broadbent in support, Wybird. And now for step himself was Darcy Clark. Can they get a mark or a ground level? Finch, dangerous. If he gathers, which he does, it'll be a goal. They're first in the grand final.
As we just spoke about, the long ball on a hot day early in the grand final, drop out the back, Finch crumbing away. Great goal. I reckon that needs to be the pattern of play, at least for the next 10 or so minutes. Just take the ground that's available, long kick and let your crummers get to work. Great goal by Peel and a real settler.
He's now kicked 23-22, so he's in front of the ledger. 50-50 before today, but he's a dangerous forward.
You'd take nearly 50 shots at goal, wouldn't you?
Absolutely. Broadbent in the ruck, searching for it was Hall. He gets it back now. Peel enjoying a nice spell here. If they can use the footy going forward, they can ask some real questions of this West Perth defence.
They seem to even up the clearance count, so it's five apiece at the moment, or six apiece, so... they've done their work on the stoppages of the Peel.
Hall for Finch. Oh, he played on. 45 out. Impossible angle. Kicks towards the goal mouth. At the back, able to take a mark was Taylor. And so Peel lock it in. Good tackle laid by Michael.
See Clay Hall on the top of the possessions count for Peel. He's starting to get his hands on it a lot and having an impact on this game early.
Son of a gun.
Yeah, Derek Hall, obviously... played a few games at West Coast and Geelong and in the WAFL as well.
Broadbent won the knock. Sherwood down the line by hand and some strong body use by Waring.
Just with that last one from Finch too, we had the mark inside 50. Play onto the boundary line. It's a tough one. Have a breather and at least give your teammates chance to set up in defence as opposed to rolling. And I think it was a half shot. You might be able to find something a little bit easier.
Yeah, I've got Tregenza lurking, so... yes, perhaps that was his best option. Sherwood receives. A wobble up. Waring. We attacked the footy. Took the mark. Gets to 50. Doesn't strike it all that cleanly. But, oh, the mark was dropped by Carboni. He'd like to have another go at that. Michael.
And giving away the free kick too. Threw his West Perth opponent to the ground. Behind play. Unnecessary. Frustrated he dropped the mark. There is a slight breeze wobbling around. But
That being said, the free kick... has actually held back West
They're
Perth.
They're open through the corridor if they look, West Perth.
Well, instead, they've copped it straight up onto the chest of Torrent. Now, he's a noted goal kicker. Kicked two goals in the second semi-final. Has 10-6 next to his name, but it'll take his very best. We saw Jake South in the reserves from about this range get the job done.
He's a nice high half forward.
He's played a lot of footy across half-back, Reece Torrent, this year, so... but to kick 10-6 has been a good effort.
It fades. Big launch came from Draper. Nothing doing there. But West Perth seeing the defence at least seeing a lot more of the footy than they would like in the back half of this quarter. Hand pass by Klepsik. Hasn't touched it too many times today. Oh, Mark Carboni, is it paid?
Good call.
No. There was some animation.
Yeah.
It came in like a quick slips catch. In fact, at ground level was Martelli who has the shiny boots. Looking dangerous here. Spree. Draper. Brilliantly stolen. Kicks the goal. Peel in front.
Big Josh Draper. Big 196 centimetre key forward. Fremantle NGA product. He's had a few nice moments in this game with some clean ball handling and finishes off beautifully with a goal.
And I just love saying this because 90% of these players probably do. A basketballing background as well.
Absolutely, that one. Yeah. He missed 12 weeks of footy this year with a really bad ankle injury. So
yeah,
he's
right.
Been back the last 3 weeks. So pleasing to see him have any impact so far.
Broadbent won the knockdown. A couple of fumbles by Peel players, but Chewia at ground level did a lot of the grunt work. It's a live ball. Chewier again. Ooh. Will he have his legs taken out? No. Umpire lets them roll and probably...
I don't mind it, Ski.
Absolutely. It was, yeah. If there were legs taken out, which I don't think there were.
No, just low and hard. Good contest. Well done, boys.
Yeah, it's a good game of footy. Seen one grand final go down to the last minute or so. Could be ball there against Julian.
He gave himself the free kick.
Hall just looks laterally immediately.
Long option. Definitely go long option. West Perth forwards, defenders are sitting off.
Rush wants to do the step. Now he's in trouble. Finds a bit of space. Kicks to a nice area. Really good kick. And there's the height we talk about. This time it's Broadbent. They've got Tregenza, Broadbent, and they, as they say, aren't getting any smaller this afternoon.
Didn't make a lot of sense there with the time. The West Perth defenders were sitting 15 metres from their opponents. It just, you've got to tighten that up, close that gap, so at least you compete in the air. That was too easy.
No, absolutely. Big Riley Sprigg. Brody pushed forward after the ruck contest, and Riley Sprigg was stuck at centre-half back, left him on his own.
Here's Broadbent. Get a couple of goals in the second semi-final. That breeze just gets hold of it. Right to the goal mouth. Still a light footy. Kick back in boards, okay. And Torrent has the mark. Well, the West Perth defence, Ryan Lascock, would be absolutely fuming.
Well, big Josh Draper again. Another clean pickup and a beautiful, some really nice composure there to not just blaze away at the goals and found a target in Reece Torrent.
And we have seen a couple of times they've blazed away early, Peel. That was great composure by the big man.
So we've seen a few players take shots from the broadcast side. The breeze took it to the left. What's going to happen here with Torrent? It's not a bad effort. He's nailed it. They've kicked three in a row.
Again here we see Draper with nice clean hands and composure to find Reece Torrent. And he adjusted from his first set shot on goal and finishes beautifully for his seventh touch already for this game, and one goal, one to his name.
Gee, that was good composure by Draper to pick it up firstly cleanly amongst the congestion, and then you're only 3 or 4 metres from goals, but to take it back 30 metres and find an uncontested mark, very good football.
Margin out to 9. Broadbent in the ruck. Dewey's been terrific. Broadbent, Hall's been outstanding. His kick was run down. Trying to be a little too cute by half and a free kick. Easy call for the umpire there. High contact. And here's the main man of this week, Kane Bevan.
Just 4 touches early.
Jack Clark, medalist. Needs to get moving. He gets a spiral to this. DeMassi, though, in the way. Uses his teammate in Selwood.
Which way is this going to go?
Let's go back to Peel. Well, hang on. Yes, it is Peel's ball.
He jumped very early, so I think that's the right call.
Yeah.
Donaghy to take the...
Trying to take the advantage. Back you come. So this quarter should roughly go for about 30 minutes with 5 goals clicked. If my maths are correct.
Well, I'm not always guaranteed of that, Zabe.
Siren sound within a second.
Absolutely. Selwood. And they're just chewing up some seconds here, Peel. And they really have lifted themselves, not off the canvas, but they look in a bit of trouble as Chewy up.
Well, 2 goals in 2 minutes early, you think, gee, Whittaker's need to get your foot in the ground pretty quickly. And they've kicked 3 in a row and had 6 scoring shots in a row.
This fellow Hall's been terrific. Donaghy, too much heat on that kick. Now he has an issue or two. Tackled by Cabalza. He's good. So good, he's rewarded. Think about a minute and a half remaining or less as we head towards quarter time. Trevitsky back to the middle. Broadbent. Oh, he played on. Wants to use the hands. DeMassi. What's happened here? 50-metre penalty.
50.
Not sure about that.
No, either of mine. He should have given the handball straight away as well. I know it's going to work now. He can just charge and send this into a very open forward line.
The big man just loping through the middle of Leaderville Oval. Tell you what, the kick wasn't bad. And it gives Jackson Klepczyk the opportunity after the siren to turn this into a 15-point margin.
I tell you, you mentioned there the kick wasn't bad. Jackson Broadbent, he's got some fantastic skills for a big ruckman. Rare to see a big ruckman that can kick on both sides of his body the way that he does.
And that was great football. I mean, to understand that he's got 50 metres, time's running out, got a big backside on him straight through the middle. It's good football.
Reminded me of Justin Madden running through Waverley all those years ago. Probably a better kick than Big Harry. Klepczyk, 52 out. Need his very best effort. And just fading off to the left-hand side. But Peel Thunder would be delighted with what they produced in this opening quarter after being jumped with a two-goal head start against West Perth. What a day it is in Leederville. And to find out what's happening in Footyville, the sights, the sounds, here's Lockie Byrne. Moving, and in the blink of an eye, they grabbed the lead. At quarter time, they're out by 10.
Yeah, that's right, Ski. They've got the moving okay. Uncontested possession, that's where they dominated the back end of that quarter. Everything else is pretty even, inside 50s, etc. They're finding the marks, the uncontested marks, and using the uncontested football pretty well, Peel Thunder. Didn't see a lot from West Perth after the first 2.5 minutes.
Great result for Peel, given what happened to them. Let's check in with the boys downstairs, Tyson alongside Jordan.
Well, Ski, just like you mentioned, in the West Perth huddle, uncontested possession. Ryan Lascock really concerned about 26 for the opposition. They need to man up and get the ball moving down the ground in their possession. What about Peel, Jordan?
Oh, Peel, Danny Charters, their coach, said they were, you know, hit in the face early, but really happy with how their problem solved on the go and how they responded. Still, tackle count was down a little bit in contested possession, but, yeah, pretty happy at quarter time.
Was that south-easterly breeze not a big factor, but it is slightly favouring the northern end, Peel's end, this quarter?
Thanks, Tyson. Jordan, Jones, your thoughts?
Yeah, I think the midfield battle was early won by West Perth, and then Peel were able to get on top of that and get the ball deep inside 50 and got some lucky goals on the end of it.
Second quarter brought to you by Amy, Colts Grand Final. West Perth and Peel, we are underway. Beautiful sunny day on the warm side as Finch had it momentarily. Carboni searching for it. Chewy has been busy. Hand pass was knocked down, but he retrieved the situation. And some real heavy work going on at ground level. Ball up.
Going to be fascinating to see throughout the day. If West Perth's two games in 4 weeks, going to give them a bit more energy, a bit more juice in the tank to keep going for the longer in the day.
Stoppage, Bevan. Extracted it, got the hand pass away. Tomasi, really well, just keeps it going in Peel's direction until Damati intervenes and finds Bevan.
Need a big quarter from Bevan. 6 disposals in the first one. The star of the competition. What a fantastic frame he's got on him too.
Michael out to Moritz. Michael's run on, given his defender an option. Game surely can't go at the frenetic pace of the first quarter for the rest of the game. Edwards, Sprigg. Now, Sprigg was very conscious of his opponent. And as a result, Edwards took the footy over the line and out of bounds.
Yeah, the ruck contest throughout the day is going to be a fascinating one. Big Riley Sprigg in the Colts team of the year up against two State 18s Academy members in Mitch Edwards and Jackson Broadbent.
Here's Edwards here. Sprigg takes clean possession. Kick didn't have much on it. Roberts is there, but brilliantly taken out of his fingertips by Garraway. An entry. Nothing doing there. And Clark with the intercept. So just a more subdued start to this quarter. Travitsky did some fine work in that opening term. Pack sets. No mark taken. Finch had the ball jarred free. Chewy just eyes intent on the footy. Scoops it out, looking for a teammate. And the whistle is blowing.
For some of these young guys, Jonesy, when does draft camp or anything like that happen?
So, yeah, there's a number of boys training for that at the moment. And on the 8th, 9th and 10th of October, the national draft, the combine. And then the state combine is on the 16th of October here in Perth.
Donaghy, Hall. High footy, West Perth well represented, they should be, and do take the defending mark in Skander, and they break quickly.
They've got overlap here out the wing. If they don't overuse it and take their time, they've got 3v2.
Kick is a beauty.
And then one in the corridor, if they roll that way.
Rance just sets it up nicely, and Farrow, who started like a bomb.
Bevan's worked forward and he's just sort of been ignored the whole way. If they kick it over the back, chance off one step.
And possibly caught in two minds.
Absolutely. And Bevan, he's actually very strong overhead. Played all his junior footy, key forward, key defence. Mm. Only in the last 18 months he's transitioned to midfielder. So it would have been nice to bob it up.
But just give it the length and he was out the back with a... probably could run into an open goal, but caught in two minds.
Logan from the back pocket sets it across the face of goals. Damasi or... Chewy with some work to do here. He'll have some company pretty shortly from Bevan, who did the 360, got the tackle applied, but managed to free the arms. Flipping the hand pass over the top was Taylor. Peel's pressure is good. Comes back to Taylor. Bouncing ball, well trapped by Logan. Playing in defence, he can go forward and kick a goal, mind you. And Edwards, well, he's paid the mark when it wasn't, but no damage done. What's the kick like?
Lovely.
It's sublime. Well, Finch has dropped what he should have just eaten up. And now it's a ball up. But, gee, there's been some interesting for the talent that some of these players have, whether it's a breeze or the moment.
There's the sun. I don't know. That sort of seemed like the sun might have even been in the eyes or something. That was a
sweat in the hand. It's pretty hot out there. There might be a bit of dew in the hand.
Let's see. Handled that pretty quickly and well, but sockers it out of the congestion. Rush with some space. Chewier. Oh, the hand pass.
They're tied.
Already?
Yes. Yeah. Certainly are.
So, what we're saying here is any lead that Peel can establish.
Well, yeah.
Like a wet weather day.
It's going to be running in mud, essentially. Your leg's going to be that heavy after half time.
Well, it was labelled Lake Leadable in the middle of winter, but to be fair, it's absolutely looking a picture compared to what it was. And a great afternoon of footy coming up. Great contested footy. Sherwood, this will be ball. It'll be a West Perth free kick.
Great strong tackle by Sherwood. Another one of their midfielders with big strong body.
And he eighth disposal. Eighth disposal there.
And you got the red hair and the zinc. And it's going to be a hot afternoon for the young man, but he's got a heap of talent. Edwards, always best position to take this. The switch is on. And a 50-metre penalty.
Oh, costly. Wow. Tukes a turnover in the corridor.
He punched the air to Edwards, but he realised that this puts him... Well, if not in scoring range, certainly on the cusp of it.
This is where you hope the umpire loses count. They give you 60 and not 50. But no, he hasn't. No, this is the top of the square job, has to be.
You think so? Edwards. Well, he had plenty of distance, but not the right kick for the occasion.
No limitations. Shannon Hearn would say swim between the flags. I think that one's probably better suited. Just to go to the top of the square, and you got your first goal of the game due to a crumb, and that was probably another opportunity there.
Sherwood, an early bounce. Oh, the hand pass. Interesting for Julian. Back to Sherwood. Lonnie. It's a bit panicked by West Perth, that passage of play. Almost a juggler to Demandley. Didn't take it. But you're right, it just feels like the tempo of the game, just through the conditions, it's decreased by 20%.
No, absolutely. And you sort of feel like West Perth need a goal here, don't they? After their blistering start, they're looking a little bit nervy, coming out of defence, a little bit of overuse.
Torrance from the stoppage. Little pitches. Chewier, he knows no other way than at the footy. Finch couldn't quite. Chewier gets boot to it. And not a bad result there for Peel. Michael gets fist on footy, but it's a territory game.
It's always debatable, the path to the grand final. Peel battled Harden. They've played every finals week, where West Perth have had two games off, finished top of the ladder.
Similar in the league later on today.
We said that last week at the MCG, but didn't quite pan out with having the Harden run, as Sydney did. But horses for courses. Michael under duress as well. And Peel's forward pressure is... absolutely elite at the moment.
Setting up well too. They look up West Perth and they do exit, and there's two spares. Sitting straight down the line, three spares.
25 out. Peel attacking. Sprigg, Tregenza. Oh, bounces in front of both ruckmen on that occasion. Michael with a clearing kick, but he's put it five rows back.
Now, this isn't a hard kick. Run around and just get it to that hot spot, they call it, and let the big guys fly and the small boys scrub.
Wearing does just that, although it's just angled a bit too far, you'd think, for what a leaping forward would want.
A poor kick. It needs to be 5 metres from the top of the goal square. Everyone knows where it's going to go. Too hard there, 1 metre from the goal line, for anyone to do anything with that.
What can West Perth conjure here? Cabalza back up towards Gathercole, now to the wing. Lonnie, kick wasn't terrific. Under siege was Gathercole. Throw, advantage paid. As a result, Hall goes for broke. A one-on-one, Traginza almost. They still look dangerous. Tackle was terrific. Held up.
Geez, the nerves of West Perth are a little bit worrying. They had the easy transition going forward. You missed the target, gather Cole. Ball gets transitioned back, and now Peel in danger of kicking another goal.
These numbers too, just waiting for this to exit. They'll snap this up.
They do get the ball out of defence. Moritz. But now Rush, forward pocket. Here's a snap. Donaghy throws a head back. He knew when he hit it that it wasn't on line. But let's be honest, after the first 120 seconds...
It's been all Peel Thunder, hasn't it?
Yeah.
9 scoring shots to zip. Inside 50, 16, 13, but it doesn't feel like that. It does not feel like they've had 13 inside 50s. West Perth, maybe they are just those shallow, non-threatening inside 50s they've been getting. They just need to hold the footy here. Great mark there.
Yep. To Manly.
Big switch on.
And Sherwood steps in board. Looking for the big man. Oh, Donaghy. Spreak chopping the arms. Well, it's a mark. It's paid.
Again, the kick not to advantage. Turnover. Peel back inside 50.
If this hits the deck, watch out for Finch and Co. Not to be the case. And Gather Cole collaborating with Michael. West Perth able to play it pretty well. That was a good result. Inside ball for Belzer.
And I don't mind that. There was a handball with a teammate jogging past. You can just see there. Get the oxygen in. Give your teammates a chance to get back down the field.
Almost the wing. Logan had a large piece of that. He paid the mark. Torrent was taken down. Hands on hips and on knees midway through the second quarter. And we feel for the boys because they would not have been used to this since, what, pre-season? Mid 20 degrees. Edwards scrapping for it. Slick hands by DeManley. Good tackle, ball.
Deanne Roberts
is rewarded.
16-year-old. We've got two 16-year-olds in this game. Deanne Roberts from Peel and Trent Hiscox from West Perth. So fantastic tackle. He's one of the co-captains in the State 16s this year.
Roberts, percentage play down the line. Broadbent, not sure he had a whole piece of that. Chewier, good release, hand pass to Torrent. Down the line, really nice. And Peel able to hit their targets in this passage of play. This is Klepsig. The run of Torrent, not sure that was to his advantage. Back to Klepsig, kick required. And the kick, well, it's a bit of a scrabble, let's be honest. It's a poor ball inside 50, and it didn't need to be the way. Moritz with the mark.
Spot on, Skeet. Torrent is actually a left footer. He's running onto his right. Wasn't quite the option, and he lost his footing and the turnover for West Perth.
Michael has been called upon a fair bit in this second quarter. Moritz, it's a lovely kick for Sherwood. Can they create something here? 2-on-1, Logan. Opposed to Hiscock. Player held without it.
West Perth kicking off one step a lot. Even then, it was just as soon as you kick off one step, I've only known about two or three people that can do it properly, and they were one Brownlow. So you just got to get back and kick through the footy.
I thought you were going to say a Rioli, and that probably comes to mind as well. Intercept mark by Bryce. Hall, that's a lovely kick. Just taking something off it, Martelli. Players through the middle, and yep, that'll do. Opportunity for Torrent on his left. Unguarded goal square. This will hurt. Well, it's hit the stick.
It's a get out of jail card there for West Perth. And the turnovers through the midfield is what's killing them this quarter. They're getting their hands on the footy, but they just can't transition the ball efficiently to their forward half.
The Falcons, after a very bright start, really struggled to hit the scoreboard. Lonnie from Moritz. Outside defensive 50. Doesn't like what he sees ahead, so all the way back.
The only thing is, there's not
Skinder.
Much out here either, Skeet.
Moritz.
When you're getting rolled 10 scoring shots to Zill since the first two scoring shots, you feel absolutely knackered because you're chasing your opponent everywhere.
Garraway's kick has to be won here by West Perth. Michael under pressure. The Peel numbers around the footy. Well, the hand pass, unfortunately, by Selwood, not to the advantage of his teammates. Rance gets involved. Garraway helps out. Looping ball back through the middle. Having to have quick hands, and Garraway was on the end of it. As Bevan was involved, out towards DeMarty. With him, Clark. Boundary is the friend for Peel, but no, forget that. Going to win it himself. go to rush. There's a runner over the top. If the kick for Garbani, no, it was not great. And he missed him. Garbani once again, though, able to go back and find the footy. May have been taken over the shoulder. No whistle on the play. Draper helping out. Rush off balance. And a juggler taken by Taylor in defence.
As much as we feel like Peel is well and truly on top, it's been a goalless quarter. So no damage has really been done.
And yeah, 13 points of difference, which is nothing these days, but we do need to see a little bit of a lift from West Perth.
Just a clean passage or two, this might be an opportunity, but they haven't strung together three or four clean disposals.
Yeah, just hitting targets, that is the key here. Michael from Skender.
Big space down the wing, the big fella's getting there now.
Has to be precise with the pass.
Yeah. Off one step.
Wyburn, who's run inside, called to play on, got some tall targets to go to, and that's not a bad ball in that direction. Off hands, out the back, should be a goal. Little hand pass, came from Klepczyk, inside 50, Torrent squeezes one home.
Well, there's that long kick in on the Amy replay. Torrent's having himself a day. 12 disposals, two goals, two already. But here's the, that's the handball to the goal. But Wybert, I thought, was fantastic. Took the man on the mark, ran laterally. The man on the mark was a bit lazy. Took the 5 or 6 metres available, and then that was the distance he needed to get the ball out over the back. Pure thunder, crumbed it and kicked the goal. And look at that run, last 10 scores. Well, it's in the last 11, technically, but well and truly on top.
12 goals for the season for Torrent, and this margin getting a little worrisome for West Perth as Wybert collided into his own teammate. Pressure enormous. Hand pass by Gathercole. Intercepted. Inside 50. That's a terrific effort low down. He always looked for the big boys in the air. But Tregenza, Cashel, found it at his bootstraps.
He's very good below his knees, Corey. He's very capable overhead. But it's his ability at ground level which really makes him a dangerous key forward.
At the risk of the commentator's curse, he has kicked 28-14 this year. So
back to the centre bounce. I'm marking it in as we speak, Scoot.
There's a fluky breeze in the house. So we'll wait and see. But Tregenza from 48. That is a delightful strike. And Peel are putting West Perth to the sword in the grand final.
And another Amy replay sees Corey Tregenza take a nice low mark and finish beautifully. You can tell he might be a little bit fatigued. The celebrations were a little subdued to what we used to from Corey.
Yeah, he goes off his rocket.
He loves it. Yeah, he's very good on the celebration. But as you can see, 9 of the last 10 inside 50s for Peel.
My notes say a traditional full forward. You can see there, mark on the chest, go back, beautiful set shot. It's not hard.
So it's been
what is hard. But I mean, if you do it so well, you can find yourself 5 kicks, 5 goals for a day.
49-point turnaround, down by 12, and now, 37-point turnaround. It's been extraordinary as Finch
dangerous
clearance.
Spot.
Absolutely. Another mark. 15 out directly in front. Here's the young man we like to keep a close eye on, Edwards, in the ruck, but this time pushing forward. They've got some height to trouble, yeah. West Perth.
Well, their tools have been exceptional today. Edwards is 17-year-old, am I right in saying?
17-year-old, yeah, so he's got another year in the Colts system, and he's looking a very likely prospect for next year.
Edwards, 25 out. You can hear the roar. You can feel the energy, the thunder extend.
Another Amy replay here. Finch with a beautiful kick inside 50. And Mitch Edwards is too much height on Luke Michael at 205 centimetres. And we've mentioned before, he's a Fremantle NGA prospect. But unfortunately, with the rules these days, if you get taken inside the top 40, you go to the club that is called the name.
So no free hit. Like he might be within the top 40 if things pan out next year.
Yes, very, very good observation there.
Umpire puts it down. Either Ruckman with a hand on it, Sherwood. In fact, Bevan emerges with it. Lays it off. Long ball by Garraway. And now they get one finally in close range. And Farrow, who's been their only target thus far, going back for a look at his third.
Well, it was the work around the clearance, wasn't it? Bevan got his hands onto it, got it out into space. worked hard, and then with the rules, you can only have one-on-ones, and was too strong.
It's very reminiscent of how they scored their goals in the first quarter. They get the clearance.
And Barrow has missed, I think.
Well, hang on.
Well, there's some dispute here.
They're coming upstairs, Skeet.
Peel players are adamant. They're not coming anywhere near us because we don't have the technologies, Dave, as you know.
I don't think...
Peel players are devastated. They are absolutely... they are determined to show the umpire that is a point.
Well, the boundary umpire standing on the point post won't be able to help, but, yep, point.
Big miss as well.
Yeah, huge. 10 metres out.
You can see by Noah's reaction, yeah. I reckon he knew it.
Like
the point.
A bit of Tom Lynch about him?
Yeah, a bit of Tom Lynch.
Yeah, it's one they would have loved because as it stands, 30-point margin, half-time not far away. Up to the wing, almost. And Peel had the numbers over the footy. Donaghy. Good run provided by Carboni, but he's not happy with the kick, nor should he be.
No, but I know, as I said earlier, I haven't seen a hell of a lot of Colts football, but it doesn't seem like West Perth have the five or six players or someone who hasn't seen a lot that can turn the game. The five or six best players on the ground have clearly been wearing a Peel jumper today.
Moritz.
You're spot on there, Zabe. Like their midfield has been exceptionally strong all year. And I suspect after halftime they'll catch their breath and they'll come out really, really strong. But they're getting beaten and outrun at the moment.
Julian down the line.
Oh,
trying to just toe poke it forward was Farrow. Now to Marty. He's got some pace, got some tricks, he's got some skills, but he hasn't got the angle right there.
They need him to lift. Marty is in the Colts team of the year as a small forward. He's kicked a number of goals in the Colts competition this year. He needs to finish those today.
No wasting time from Selwood. Gets some good meters and a really good ball for Torrance. So the transition here could be really brisk as Broadbent, a finger tipper, not quite. And the agility at ground level means that Lonnie's able to swoop. Ball eventually, after a couple of sets of hands.
Big Torrance got the ball.
Oh, he's been nice. He's Torrance. Been very good.
And Broadbent,
he can get this in the middle too if he wants.
And likes to use the hands, does it again here for Rush. Sits up obligingly. The kick in boards, an absolute pearler. Oh, the mark was dropped. Donaghy, Finch, you wouldn't rule him out around his body. Miss.
I've got a feeling Finch doesn't mind taking aim. Small forwards, limited opportunities as a small forward. If you get it in your hands, you might as well have a ping.
And he's a bit of an agitator, hence
is
the
he? Yeah.
Ginnivan sort of methodology.
He's an exciting player.
He's had a couple of missed opportunities today.
Well, 6 goals, 8. You know, they kick. Swing that or even a little bit better and it's game over at half time. 6-8 and it's still an opportunity for West Perth to get back in it.
Garraway, seconds ticking away. Lots of Peel numbers around this footy. Oh, that's ball. Despite Rance trying to find a way through it, he was collared magnificently. Now switched on the Thunder here. Intended for Broadbent. Wasn't a great kick, really. It was way over the...
numbers heavily favouring Peel forward of the footy, though.
Bevan. Also, the kick was a little dodgy. Rush takes down his opponent with great vigour, did it legally. And again, the spotting up, the hitting of targets, yeah, just is absent for West Perth.
Now, that transition ball, moving it from defence to the forward line. Yeah, I think the heat might be playing a big, big part in their drop from off of skills.
Bevan.
But even then, too, Bevan.
Rush. And now Sherwood's over the footy, scooped up the back to the advantage of Gathercoll, but Peel continually winning the footy back, and Wybird has it near the boundary, which emerges too quickly.
So Bevan did go lateral. It was a poor kick, don't worry about that, but ahead of the football 50 metres, it was about a 6-on-2 favouring Peel. So, I mean, he's a star player, and he'd want to hit that target more times than not, but he had no one ahead of the football.
At the 50 for Peel. Bevan. Hand pass. Didn't find Datto. And he goes again. That's not bad for Alexander. All under pressure, though. Smother was pretty good. Fortuitously, Bevan is on the end of it, but he couldn't quite control it. Freed the arms. And some nice lateral movement by Julian. Sends it inside the centre square. Carboni slaps it straight down to DeMarty. Now they've got some space to operate. Farrow. Pressure on the kick, man. He didn't really get it to where he wanted to. Off the deck goes Lonnie. Peel able to hold on. Bryce If it sits, he's got a man over the top, the left foot, that's good enough. Really good kick, really. Oh, dear.
Oh,
free kick. Carboni, I thought it was a good place ball, which it was. Advantage. And DeMassi. Chop by Gian Shelley.
Did you talk about moments in a game? I think it might have been Bryce that affected the kick inside 50. It was almost a certain goal, man.
Well, it was a certain goal. West Perth player inside 50 alone. It was great pressure. On a hot day, you can choose to do it or choose not to do it, and Peel are choosing to do it.
Half time, not far away. Peel lead by 30. Hall from the stoppage. It sits, which allows Draper to make some metres and then find the boundary, which is a terrific result for the Thunder.
Hall's been outstanding today. 16 disposals, leading with Bevan, of course, at West Perth there, but the 7 handball receives. He's running hard. It's been a great first half.
Seconds ticking away. Colts grand final. Bounces off the shoulder of Broadbent. Donaghy was there. And the ball squeezed out of the congestion by Klepsic, away from the West Perth player, Mitch Lonnie.
You just see Finch enjoying a bit of shoulder-to-shoulder work with his opponent. I'm enjoying that battle.
3-4-2 behinds in favour of Peel. So they've extended their lead and look good in running as we speak. I'll take it by Sprigg. Missed the foot initially. Big Broadbent. And working close to the line, Gathercole, Lonnie and Donaghy. He's more than happy to see this back in a neutral ball.
A little bit of push and shove. Half time can only be little seconds away, you'd assume.
Just outside the 50. Again, not clean contact by Damanlik. Leaving it behind as Cabalza. And there's some weary bodies as we approach the half.
Chasing a 5-goal deficit. After half-time, you'd want to have a couple of ultra-marathon runners in your side to run over the top because we saw within 15 minutes of this game the sting sort of and the mistakes came in just because of the heat.
Is there a chance for one more? Well, Roberts, a falcon from Donaghy, and he's feeling the effects of it. Out of defence, taken by Julian. Is there time for one more surge forward for the Falcons? They get it into the hands of Rance. Next kick's important. DeMassi went to ground, importantly. That left Nelson free and a spare man in the goal square. Here we go. Eli Alexander breaks the drought for the Falcons.
Well, West Perth used their hands really well to get out of congestion. Took the bounce. And this was the high kick. There was one opportunity and just missed it. Peel there and away they went. Over the top, Joe the Goose.
Massive goal in the Alexander, context of West Perth,
huge.
Isn't it?
There must be seconds before the siren. I mean, you're going with a little bit of belief and you're 4 goals down and you've been dominated. So, plenty of belief now.
Ruckman go at it. Skender's kick just up and down, really. He gets a second look at it.
If you pinch one here, Skeet.
It's a floater. Siren can't be far away. Ball on the ground. DeMassi propels. And Peel take an advantage into the half-time of this Colts grand final of 24 points. They have been terrific after conceding the first 2 goals of this contest. They've kicked 6 goals to 1. The margin, 24 at the half. Back to the halftime show right after this. Show leaderable oval, the Colts grand final. And West Perth, Peel. Well, the Falcons kicked the first 2 of the morning, and after that, it was 6-1. A 10-point lead to Peel at quarter time. They lead by 24 at the half. Hot day, as it turns out now, at Leaderville. It's 6-8 playing 3-2.
We went into the game thinking the West Perth midfield could be dominant here, but it's actually been the Peel Thunder midfield. It's led by Clay Hall. He's on 15 touches. Reece Torrent, 15 as well, has kicked 2 goals too. And at the moment, they're leading the charge for the Thunder.
Absolutely. We saw the dominance of Peel Thunder after that opening 2 minutes where Farrow hit the scoreboard twice. But that transformation, it was a slow burn, but eventually they took control. That was a perfect start for West Perth.
2. Chest, easy chest mark to Noah Farrow. Finished beautifully. And then the wheels went off and it was all Peel Thunder. We've got Ryan Lascock, who's West Perth. JJ Leonard, Coach of the Year. Colts Coach, Team of the Year head coach. You have them in at halftime. Can he recharge their batteries and get them ready for a big second half?
Yes, what we saw from Peel Thunder, just from the commentary box, they got more avenues to goal. Finch started the fire, and then when you've got the big boys like Broadbent, like Torrent, and of course, off the outside of the boot, Draper there.
Yeah, big Draper, he has big influence on this game. The midfielders, they're transitioning the ball. Big Corey Tregenza, he's kicked a couple. Mitch Edwards took a really nice mark, finished with a goal. So they've got a number of avenues to goal, and they're stepping forward in this game in the final.
Yes, the Thunder lead by 24. West Perth getting a late goal in that second quarter. Strong mark by Edwards. We know the talent this young man possesses. And that made life really tough for the Falcons. They scored late, but the margin's still 24 points. I can tell you one place that is nice to be at the moment, the Peel Rooms, because it'll be cooler and they're in front.
No, absolutely. Danny Charters will be very happy with what his boys have produced in that first half. The message is going to be sustain it for another two quarters and the premiership's ours.
Well, you mentioned Clay Hall as being one of the prominent players in the first half. Well, thanks to Maxis, of course, we look for the player who does the most work in heavy traffic. This young man, terrific.
We mentioned son of Derek Hall. He's a big kid, big, strong body, left foot kick. He's found the footy all today and been beautiful by hand and foot, as we can see there. He's only 17, so he's got another year at Colts level, and he's got a big future ahead of him, I think.
Looks like he's got time on his side. He uses the ball well, and from West Perth's point of view, it's something they've failed to do at times today. But he is our Maxis best player in heavy traffic on this Saturday afternoon. It's warm here and even hotter. Those rooms at Peel, getting some water, getting some air conditioning into the system after a brutal first half in these conditions, having come from a winter, and West Perth with 24 points as the deficit, hoping to get themselves back into the contest. Well, of course, throughout this year, we've seen so many great marks and goals. When it comes to the contenders for the Kia Marks of the Year, we've narrowed it down to some of the very best.
Regan Clark had plenty of the footy in the first half. Inside 50, what a mark!
But for several effective rebounds from Subiaco. And there's Lissando with what a mark over the top of his marksman.
Tap was nearly one down, and it was, and Jones is going to clear out a tall big fly, and the mark was taken in.
Bartlett, that's a big fly, and the mark's going to be paid.
Where it finds Dealers. He sends it high and long, and a big fly there by Thomas Edwards.
There we have it, some of the best of the best from Kia Marks of the Year contenders in 2022. And there's some of the crowd that's just rolling in. What's going to be a huge afternoon of footy later on. It's West Perth and Claremont in the grand final in the league. Well, from the marks to the goals, and thanks to Electrical Group Training, here are some of the contenders that are coming your way this year.
One down by McInnes. Rare hit out for him towards Carey. Being quiet, fed it off to Perkasic, sells Candy, steps around another one, gets the hand pass back, this would be a great goal. He's put it through, fantastic work.
Didn't play on by the advantage over there, thanks, same Sturt, quick hands over the top to Johnson. Johnson outside 50, thumping kick from outside 50, how will it run? It's still running, and running, and running, and running for a goal. First goal to the Thunder.
Towards the fourth pocket in the Ham direction. Keeping it in brilliantly there was Knott. Great work by the little pocket rocket. Goes towards goal. A great goal by Knott. Ham pass over the top. Cooley in the back pocket. Taken strongly in the tackle. Sparks goes to ground. Almost out of room. Henry through the traffic. Banana kick from the pocket. Oh, ha, ha. What a goal, Liam Henry. Onto the right foot, towards right half forward, one-on-one, Leggett in front against Pegoraro. Leggett trying to break free, great skill from Leggett, dribbles towards goal, oh he's got it, I think he's got it, oh what a goal!
How about those contenders for the goal and the mark of the year? We will reveal the winners at half-time in our league coverage today as West Perth take on Claremont. Half-time about to come to its conclusion in the Colts. It's Peel, the team in front by 24 over the Falcons. Third quarter on the other side of this break. West Perth days.
John Duckworth, what's the atmosphere like today?
Mate, it's terrific, and like to have three sides in. West Perth have got all three sides in. Unfortunately, the Rezzies have just got beaten by a goal, but I hope the next two can get up. But it's just a great thing for the club to have all three grades in.
And what does it mean to you to have it back home in Leaderville?
Well, unfortunately, I never played in a flag here. I captained West Perth in 78, and we got knocked out in a preliminary final by South Fremantle, but it was probably a year we should have won one.
Very special day for many.
Great to see John Duckworth alongside Lockie. Now, you guys are too young to remember John Duckworth just dominating Leaderville Oval. He played in defence and wear the number one from memory, and just charged out of defence, had a booming kick on him. And, of course, his brother, Billy, went on to play a famous role with the Bombers in the 80s.
Yeah, my side as a kid, the Bombers, probably wasn't bored then, but I was a Bombers supporter, so the name certainly rings plenty of bells. To me, of course, growing up over in the East Coast and being a Bombers man.
Some of the great names that will be here today. Crowd, as we expect, will be filling this ground in excess of 14,000. Warm conditions, though, and given...
Oh, it's as hot as the sun on that outer side. Goodness me, hats on, sunscreen on, and just maybe find something water or something like that just to keep you hydrated.
One good way to do it is through INC Sports Nutrition. Of course, our third quarter coming your way. Of course, all those products available at Chemist Warehouse, INC Sports Nutrition, thanks to their wonderful support of the WAFL in 2022. And isn't it great to see so many people getting here for the finale of the season, that one day in October as it stands. Third quarter underway, Peel by 24. And that ball not coming back. Spriggs able to palm it down. Julian left it behind. Goes back to try and retrieve it, and the whistle is blown.
Going to need a big half from Griff Julian. He's a little bit quiet for his normal self in the first half, so looked like he had some good energy there.
Restart. Bevan sidesteps his way out of trouble. And attacking the footy is Nelson.
Nice run and jump, highest point.
Short ball.
Get it back.
Not to be. More deliberate here from Alexander, who kicked a late goal, an important late goal.
Peel have just got spare sitting in this hole now, though. Yeah, they are.
Lots of numbers in that vicinity. Farrow couldn't quite at ground level. Does well. Got a fist to it. Bryce able to intervene. Oops. Little dropsy from Dravitsky. Put himself under more pressure than what he'd like. West Perth just ramping up the pressure here. Rush. Tackle didn't stick. Off a step. Kick came from Nelson, and he's put it over and out.
Even if that did stay in play, the three or four Peel players just sitting underneath that. So when you're trying to get the score on the board, you can't allow Peel Thunder to set up numbers behind the play. I know that there's rules in place to stop it from centre bounces, etc. But once it's going, you've got to be able to equalise those numbers.
Have the spill taken by Bevan. Wide of the mark, a bouncing ball.
You just get the sense that Bevan's really trying to will his team back into this game. He's a little bit inefficient in the first half, but his numbers were strong.
18 disposals, efficiency 43% by foot.
You also think that if West Perth's to win the premiership, they have to make inroads in this quarter.
Oh, absolutely. And there is that fluky breeze that maybe is favouring their end this quarter.
Restart, slick hands by Chua. He found Hall, but they've turned it over. And a mark's taken about 55 out here by Clayton Taylor. Back towards Bevan, who's getting a lot of it. The kick, well, it was a short ball, speculative. Julian stripped of it. Peel's defence, that was good enough by Wybird.
For Bevan, who was obviously the player of the year, essentially, 19 disposal now, 38%. Is the kicking the one thing he's been working on or needs to work on, or is today just a bit of a down day?
Definitely an area of focus for Bev, but he's also, you know, new to the midfield. You probably wouldn't be able to tell that.
Yeah.
Like, he's been playing there for many years. But so he's still got lots of scope and improvement left in his game. But, yeah, definitely kicking is one area that he needs to keep focusing on.
Waring got the kick away. It was a nice hand pass, release hand pass by Chewia. Klepsik out wide. What's Draper got up his sleeve here?
Oh, I like this.
Puts the afterburners on. The kick a bit shallow for Edwards. Has to go down low. He held possession, which I think was probably not a bad move. He'll be penalised here, but better than an immediate turnover as we check in with Tyson Birdie downstairs.
Ski, just a bit of an injury concern with Ethan Logan from Peel Thunder. Looks like he's done a lower leg injury. He's trying to warm up and sort of run it off a little bit. He did do a knee injury earlier in the season, but he's going to try and run through it and come back onto the ground.
3-on-1 here, and that spells danger. With that Klepsik's hand pass, a real speculator. Hall absorbs the tackle, dropped it in the process. There to help out was Rance, and now Sherwood. A wide, wide ball for Taylor. Sits up. He was trying to knock it on, was he? Not sure what his purpose was there, but it was a 2-on-1. So as a result, Bryce ends up with the footy. Now it's Travitsky. Pulls it back delightfully for Draper. 55 out.
Spare inside 50 here.
Hall from Chuia. And that was Silver Service delivery. And Tregenza has the ball about 48 metres out. And just using it precisely.
You can go back to Tristan Bryce there. He came off his opponent, and it was risky. If West Perth had won the footy, then his opponent was free. But he came off, caused the outnumber, won the ball back, and now Tregenza has it, a shot on goal.
No, fantastic play. He took off. His opponent was 50 metres behind him in the end. It was a great play.
It's like a long launch from Tregenza. Begins from outside the arc. And the umpire always heading off to his right. In fact, it is out of bounds on the full. Speaking of the umpires, all the umpires in today's Colts Grand Final are debutants in the Grand Final. So, terrific reward under Dean Margetts and the team at the Footy Commission to have that spread of youth and exuberance coming through. Some have been in the system longer than others.
And what do they say, Skeet? If you don't know who the umpires are, they've done a good job, and I don't think we've noticed them once today.
No, that's correct. I'm sure that you knew the names anyway.
Smith, Rogers and Johns.
On the wing. Over the top goes Broadbent. Roberts has a couple of Falcons for company. I will give you the field umpires. Harrison, Wedgwood and Wilkinson.
They've done a good job.
Bevan somehow gets it to Julian. Inboard. Kick from to Manly, but Travitsky. They've got a breaker here. It's Rush. He'll get it from Selwood. If it sits, he can go a long way with this footy. Wants to turn back inside. The kick was, sure what the intention was there. Almost a look-away pass. As it turns out, he's coughed it up. Mark was taken at half-back by Skinder.
An evenly poised start to this quarter. You feel like whoever gets the first goal might be able to build a bit of momentum.
Michael lays it off. Opportunity for Hiscock, unable to grasp it. There's a holding decision. It'll go back to Peel and in the arms of Darcy Clark.
Big switch on if they want to have a look at it. It's all about work right now, though.
Logan guides it over the top. Has to be good and just in time. Makes its way to Thompson.
Bevan, he was a good mark.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Bevan, a big boy, used his body. Made him really earn it.
Carboni on his chest. And Peel looking at the scoreboard. Perhaps not the way to go at times. Into a sort of safety first mode.
7 minutes in, no damage done.
True. Selwood.
Good mark.
And Broadbent. I wonder how many times Michael Selwood's been asked that question. Although
he's got the double L. I would have told a few furfies of that name. Oh, yeah, Cousins.
And there's a fist on the footy coming from Cabalza. They just need something here, West Perth. That looks like someone to provide that inspirational act.
Well, Bevan's got going. He's had 20 disposals, 6 clearances, 3 tackles, 3 inside 50s. So I don't think it's him. I think someone else needs to jump in because you know what he's going to do. He set a platform as he goes in there again.
Stripped of it. Donaghy, well trapped by Lonnie, who was confronted with an awkward bouncing ball. Selwood, clean bowl, but at the back. Clark gathers beautifully, turns it over. Straight to Taylor. And a few of those today from both sides. Here's the kick intended for Marafiotti. Selwood, slipping and sliding. Still tracking him. Marafiotti breaks the tackle. It's all about the finish in the pocket. And the pressure came. It was enough. Players at the top of the square asking the question, but
he's one of those players, Mario Fiotti. He's got power, he's got pace. He's one that could help them ignite and get them back into the game.
Well, that's what I mean. You know Bevan's going to do what he's doing. He's done it all day. You just need someone else to stand up and then have one out of the box.
Bear in mind, West Perth have kicked three goals. They have to kick, well, you think, five from here.
Well, they kick one in about 60 minutes.
Absolutely. So the time is now. And Farrow grasp it with both hands.
Yeah, look, he mentioned it before. He was the difference in their final a couple of weeks ago, which got them over the line. He kicked a big goal from 50 metres out in the last quarter to put him back in front. So yeah, I think they're going to be looking for him to really kick another few goals to get him back into this game.
Noah Farrow to pull it back to 17. It's tight. It's just missed. It was on target for a long part of that journey.
He's had an opportunity to kick four, hasn't he?
2-2, yeah.
But one at the top of the goal square earlier. Yep. And that wasn't an easy shot. And he struck it pretty well. You see the breeze grab it, but he's shown enough. Just needs more opportunities.
Just a bit one-dimensional, unfortunately. Downfield kick here. Fitch took the mark in any case. He won't waste time. He'll get rolling. Messy hand pass for Clark. Makes it look good. And Draper nurses it on his chest.
Gee, I like Draper. Athletic type.
Bit of just the way he moves, Michael Johnson style.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, just clean, classy.
Finch.
That's a good kick.
Punches it hard. Watch out for the tools. And that's why it was never, as Xavier said, it was never going to be an issue of the defender being able to easily destroy that foot in. There's the big man, Tregenza, from 35 out.
You just feel if he kicks this, it could be a little bit of an energy sapper for West Perth. Oh, yeah. I know the Suns are already sapping a bit of energy, but this one could really take the wind out of their sails.
A couple of deep breaths from the young man. Five goals in the preliminary final last week. 40 out. And there is a breeze there, which is clearly doing some work to the left.
It just shouldn't affect the game later on either, but you're right, it's a little bit gusty. You can see that one there just got grabbed as well. It's hard to say if it's favouring in either end, but it's a bit swirly.
Garraway. Now Spree, 19-year-old. Ruckman Colts of the year. Julian squares the footy, so some good use here by West Perth. They need to keep this moving up through the middle. Fumble by Lonnie. Now the pressure around his body meant the kick is into a peel congested area, and Finch received it from Draper. Logan was the player launching for the mark. 3-on-1 here, surely not for Tregenza, but the idea was sound. Back to the hot spot, going to ground, dishing it off Draper. Finch needs to give.
Give a handball.
No, he wants to go himself. And I'll tell you what, there were options left and right, but he said nah.
No, that was hungry, that one. Yeah, no, that wasn't great footy. Because there was about eight people pleading for it, but small forwards.
Spring, nowhere to go. But all credit to the Thunder, as we talked about pre-game, Adam. They've had a hard run in the finals. They had Subiaco and a thriller early in the final series. West Perth, less than a goal result there, then a 10-point win over Subi.
And you'd say that it's helped them in this game. Those close games and the tough contest looks to be helping them so far.
Chewy up, Finch, what's happening here?
Nah, hasn't paid it. It was the Guinevere. Here it is. Oh, it's hard to see on the camera, but I don't know if that's the way, is it?
Could have easily have given it, but
I think it's the boy who cried wolf sometimes with a couple of players. But he's one of those...
Oh, I love small forwards. Yeah, they're great. I absolutely love them. They're great for the game.
And he does have similarities with
100%,
the
Collingwood And what'd you say earlier? 23 goals, 23 or something along those lines?
50-50.
50-50,
but the shots at goal, which, as you say, if he's not passing them off, that does help. But it's a great mix with Broadbent.
Yeah,
oh, fantastic. And a player like him makes it very ominous.
You're telling me he's not winning the goal assist award at the end of the year?
Probably not. Good battle on the outer side. Not sure it's going anywhere. Umpire calls for it. Carboni was over the top and the last man to get to his feet. Trying his heart out today, Damon Lee. Buckman eventually get to the contest. Broadbent comfortably. Carboni. The Draper direction. Tregenza was there as well. Surging through was Martelli, but to no avail. I just feel that West Perth's, I'm not sure they've got the energy level to get a momentum swing here.
Now, you'd know more than me, Jonesy, but they don't have the player type by the looks of it who could, you know, start running out of stoppages and stuff like that.
Well, that's all right. They might have to look at like a Dan Gathercole, who's got a bit of power, a bit of speed. He plays normally across half back. Do you look to throw him on ball? Isaac Demardi is a dangerous small forward. Do you hear him? Yeah. Sav Marafiotti, just give them a run through the midfield.
Big bodies on a normal day are great around the footy, but on a hot day like today, when the big bodies start to move like trucks, and then you've seen the Peel smaller frame shoot off, you might need to make a change that you haven't made for most of the year.
Quick kick through the congestion by Wybird. Hit a body. It's like a couple of prize fighters in the 12th round here at the moment.
Ryan Lascock, very experienced coach at this level. Mentioned he won the JJ Leonard for Coach of the Year. So I'm sure they're having these discussions in their box right at the moment.
Pressure's been elite, though. And a free kick will go back to a young man, Scott Chua, who I think's done a terrific job. Just his work rate, outstanding. What are his numbers there, Jonesy?
He's up to 19 possessions, so he's leading possessions with Hall on the ground. Kane Bevan.
To the goal square, Omar. Hiscock off hands. This is touched in transit as well, so it won't be a mark at ground level. Freshieri by Datto. And high contact on this occasion. West Perth ball. Hall going high. Julian with the free kick.
And there you look up now. Some of the forwards are trying to work.
Oops. Some miscommunication there. Almost a Falcon rant. Here's Wybird running onto another.
I've liked this left foot.
60 out. Good kick. Klepsig will launch. Oh, brilliant mark going back, Luke Michael. Outstanding.
We've seen that a lot this year, Luke Michael. Just courage in the air, reads it beautifully. And can that lift his side?
Sherwood wanted to move, had Lonnie on down the line. Now the exits have been blocked up.
Carbone almost 50. They won't worry about this Peel.
No damage taken.
No damage. They're not getting spread. They're not running from one side of the ground to the other. It's virtually stand there and get your breath back at the same time.
Garraway, sensing a change is required, goes all the way back to Sherwood. What they failed to do is hit targets in the process.
This has been a good spread out here.
Yep, Demardi got it from Jesse Taylor. And now a bit of space to operate. Moritz. Farrow caught behind, forced to spoil. And a crafty bit of defensive work by Logan ensures that goes over and out.
Moritz was on this grandstand side wing moments ago. And when we said it was a dead play and not much was happening, he decided to get to the other side of the ground. That was a fantastic run.
It was great running. He had big Joshy Draper chasing him, who hasn't played much footy this year. He spoke about the ankle injury, so using his advantage with his fitness, Moritz.
Ball bounces to the back, claimed by DeMassi. Makes some good meters, to be honest. Klepsik, clever. Wybird. In the blink of an eye, they're almost at half forward. 2-on-1, though. West Perth will prevail. Kicked by Skender. Now, out wide. Mark, 45 out, and the ruckman has it. Riley Sprigg.
That's just what they're called for. Better use by Bevan there. Hits his target inside 50. And to say that the Falcons need this is an understatement. It's going to be a tough kick from where he is.
But they're only one goal away from going to three-quarter time, yeah. Believing.
We hadn't probably seen enough of that from West Perth. They need to start moving the ball a little bit quicker, take a few more risks and see what can unfold.
Kick. Right to the goal mouth. Farrow, not quite. Will they concede? Was that high contact? Had to be a free kick, not given. And West Perth supporters throw their heads back in dismay.
You could tell the reaction of the Peel play. He panicked. Here it is, dropped. It was the too high here.
Oh.
That initial arm, mate.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to retract. Umpire played it pretty well.
Yeah, no, I'm not filthy about that. But I have a dog in this fight, so.
Logan. Oh, Clemson. Good the accidental mark. Hero there. Wants to step and does. Pretty comfortably around Ginchelli. sliding effort. Chewy up, got it from Donaghy. At the 50, Hall, watch out. Still got the hand pass away. West Perth win it back. Back to the middle, Rance. Bevan. And now Nelson says, chase that. 65 out. Time to assess. On the lead. He had Sprigg. He went wider than that. And the result is not a good one.
Stephen, that by Bevan. And don't get me wrong, he's their best player by a million miles. A 15-metre pass, but he just misses and it sends his teammate running out towards the boundary line. There's a bit of pressure because it's not 15 play on.
Bryce flirting with danger here. One mistake. Could be fatal. Turnover. Farrow. Marafiotti. And they throw their arms out absolutely aghast.
You know you're under the pump too when you are having a shot. And I think he probably was warranted there to have a shot. And the teammates throw their arms out wanting the football. It's a side who are desperate to kick the next to try and keep this game alive. I know we're not at three-quarter time yet, but with heat like today.
Shallow kick, Farrow, juggler. He's kicked two, could have four. He's been their only threat, let's be honest. Lateral ball, Sherwood.
No real tall sitting in the hole at the moment.
He's a big kick.
It's a Sherwood. Deep kick. It's a big booming ball. The special moment the Falcons required. Sherwood from the forest.
Well, we just needed to see something from West Perth. INC Sports Nutrition replay. And Sherwood from about 55 has sunk the slipper into that. And there's the pulse, 16 points. And they've been on top the last 4 or 5 minutes.
Great for the game. Great, hopefully it really gets the energy levels going from West Perth.
Not many goals in this quarter, so we're thinking 27, 26?
27 minutes or something. There's a new formula, Skeet, somehow.
Like the Duckworth
Lewis.
This plus
this equals that, yeah.
Duckworth Lewis system.
Yeah. When the siren goes, it'll be right.
Here's the game on. Bevan, terrific tackle. They win it back here at West Perth. Taylor, inside 50, got past Alexander. It's a fluky bounce, but he couldn't control it. Selwood and Peel are going up and down the one spot at the moment. Lonnie. Now Clark flips it out the back. There's two players here. Wearing wants to give it away straight to Garboni. Around the body. Ball sits on its end. Finch tacked the man. The ball did it well. Win for Peel there.
There's a bit of a telling stat. There's 17 marks to 2 West Perth's favour in the last 10 minutes. So they're using the footy a little bit better. They've been trying to play the possession game most of the day. Their efficiency levels are improving. So
absolutely.
Hopefully they can see it on the scoreboard.
Sprigg tapped down. Julian, the recipient, over the top. Looking far more ominous here, although that lateral ball, not sure, from Rance. Alexander. One-on-one. Oh, brilliant. Overhead. Nelson. 52 out. Marafiotti.
It's amazing how a goal can just lift the energy levels of the whole team. You can see them all really starting to run on like they've had an injection of energy.
Well, he kicks this and then you start to wonder what camp you're in terms of favouritism. They've shot to life the last 10 minutes and really got the game back on their terms.
Saverio Marafiotti. There's a few syllables there. There'll be a few screams of delight if he can slide this home. He's had some chances, hasn't he?
He has had some opportunities. Zero goals, a 3 on the day.
Gee, a goal before three-quarter time for West Perth means the world, doesn't it?
Oh, huge.
Can they get that vital six-pointer, Dravitsky? And there's a free kick shepherding. Bevan has it, he'll be giving it back.
Yeah, Marafiotti there, just a bit overzealous with the block.
Tried to do the team thing, but probably didn't need to do it. Bevan had read it really well and knew it was going to land. But sometimes you don't get the reward when you're trying to do the right thing.
Broadbent, as Adam Jones suggested, pretty good by foot. Hits Roberts. Dan Roberts. A couple of Peel players fall to ground. As a result, there's the overhead specialist. Taking the mark, Luke Michael.
Very good footballer, Luke Michael.
Bevan, oops, that hand pass. Finally, they hit Julian. Bit of space ahead. Great tackle! Inspirational by Bryce, the big boy. And almost got a 50-metre penalty. That's a 50-metre penalty, which wasn't awarded. He's very lucky. The West Perth player gave it back to another Peel player. But look at this.
Wow.
Geez, if Peel Thunder get up, they're going to watch the replay, and Tristan's going to be getting high fives from a number of teammates with a couple of these crucial plays that he's made.
My notes on Tristan Bryce, $1 to be toughened into Barney at some stage. Well, he's tough.
And that's your world, Xavier. For those that don't follow, that's almost a certainty.
Yes. Likes it tough.
Oh, stabbing ball, not really to the advantage of his teammate in Roberts. Got it back in Torrent.
Good
terrific mark by Sprigg. Now, Peel are like, speaking of horse racing, like a galloper that needs a finish line three-quarter time at least. 24 minutes have gone.
And if you're Peel, you certainly can't give one away on the rebound, but you still got to keep going. So if you're West Perth, because you do have the momentum, and if you can get that next one, then the seed of doubt is well and truly placed.
Rance lays it off. Kick came from Cabalza. Defensive punch. Peel desperately trying to hang on here. Albeit they lead by 15. The whistle is blown. Seconds tick away.
We need to see a fall of the ball there from the West Perth small forwards. They've got the ball in plenty of times. They've brought it to ground, but they just haven't had the smalls around the contest.
Edwards. Here's Bevan. Spun into trouble. Now Farrow lays a good tackle. And a contest after contest, and the umpire did it pretty well there.
What did we calculate?
Yeah, it's soon.
So?
But if I was Bevan, I'd be running towards goal. Don't get towards the boundary line.
Edwards, here's Selwood. Kept in play, interestingly. Julian. His use of the body by Bryce was outstanding. And Alexander just pushed aside too comfortably.
Yeah, great strength. There's two great bits of play when Peel have needed a settler. He stood up.
Bryce, long ball. Michael was there, off hands. Taken by Torrent. Finch, gets out to Donaghy. They can open up on the other side to a one-on-one. Right half forward. Tregenza couldn't. Chewia looking for Wybird. Will it stay in? It does. Has he got the wheels? He couldn't quite break the tackle. Taken by Waring. The defender pushing forward. And not a bad result. Half volley into the behind post.
You love seeing from your key forward, Corey Tregenza. He didn't mark the ball, but he brought it to the front of the contest. All their small forwards are told to get forward of the ball, and there they were.
Three-quarter time, the grand final. It's 16 scoring shots to 11. It was a 24-point lead to the Thunder at halftime, but West Perth are showing some fight. Can they get off the canvas? They trail by 15, one quarter to go in the Colts season of 2022. Staring at the gun tonight. Don't go turning the lights down on me. Two in that third quarter to give them just a chance as they head into the final quarter of this one.
Well, you can see there, it is pretty even, and you're right, Bevan has been great. Absolutely hats off to him. But he needs to be better again in this quarter to give West Perth the opportunity to beat Peel Thunder, who the breaks did slowly come on in that quarter.
That's right. You can see the worm just edging back towards West Perth, but they've still got a lot of work to do. If they can get an early goal in this last quarter, it's going to go all the difference.
Uncontested, Jonesy, you spoke about at quarter time. Uncontested disposals evened up, and that probably suggests the game is wrestling back into West Perth's favour.
That's right. They seem to be a little bit more efficient, but with their use by foot that quarter, linking some ball, moving forward. But it was just that last kick at goal where they missed a couple. Tab Marifriotti missed a few. Noah Farrow missed some difficult chances. But if they can get a couple of those to go in, and you saw the energy that they got from that goal in the third quarter, who knows what can happen in this last quarter.
And a little bit of energy, and it doesn't count for a lot, but the West Perth senior players are just warming up around the West Perth huddle as they disperse now. And Aaron Black and those guys get around and give a pat on the back. That lifts you a little bit too.
West Perth in that quarter, 1-5-2 behind. So let's check in with our boundary riders, Tyson Beattie, Jordan McArdle.
West Perth coach Ryan Lascock was really happy with the run and the way they played one-on-ones in that third term. They got on top in the uncontested possession, and he thinks that they can get the job done here and overrun Peel in this last term. What about the Thunder, Jordan?
Oh, Danny Charters, it was all about not going into their shell and just playing attacking footy. They said, you know, one quarter to go, and, you know, just don't change the way they've been playing all day.
The first goal is going to be really, really important. It's going to be a big final term, boys.
There we have it. Last quarter brought to you by Max's Tyres. Fourth quarter. Who's going to be able to negotiate their way through heavy traffic in the biggest quarter of the season?
If you had to put your stake in the ground,
always take the team that's in front.
Yeah, I'm with you there, Skeet. I think Peel.
I'm going upset. I know it's out there a little bit. I reckon the last 15 minutes was so dominant West Perth. First goal, interesting.
Underway, and it's Hiscock who's in the ruck and giving them some early metres. Ball locked up.
Big call from Ryan Lascock, putting a 16-year-old in the ruck, but he did well there, jumping over Jackson Broadbent to win the first knock.
What we saw, what I've seen through some Colts matches this year with this rolling clock, that late in the game becomes an issue as Donaghy out wide to the wing. Damati worked over the boundary line.
More of an issue too, of course, with today, usually 25-minute flat quarters, but today with some breaks after the goal, the clock will stop. So we don't know exactly when the siren's going to go, but it won't be much after the 25-minute mark.
Pending the goals, yes, correct. Broadbent from behind here. Wybird, Hall, Traper. Broadbent's hand pass was knocked down brilliantly by Julian. Now he's got an issue. Didn't have prior. But all these stoppages, one after one, if you're the coach of Peel, you're not looking at the clock every second, but you think, right, 1 minute down.
No, you probably are looking at the
clock. I would be, as you rightfully would, knowing what's at stake. Half a clearance for West Perth. Rush couldn't do much with it. Travitsky didn't get boot to it. Good tackle laid on Datto. At the back, Chewy up. That's a terrific defensive but creative handball for Rush.
Chewy has been fantastic. 24 disposals, just updated. Had a huge game.
Wybird punches it hard. Oh, ricochets past a couple of West Perth defenders. Around the body. Kicked by Peel. Logan has gone forward. Smothered by the defence of West Perth in Skender. And I've noticed Logan played forward in a final earlier this campaign.
Yes, and kicked a number of goals. So Danny Charters has seen an opportunity to ice the game and sent one of their star players forward. And
an attacking move.
Yes, very attacking move. So he almost got one there, so could pay off for them.
Edwards opposed to Bevan, so the captain's being asked to do everything. Here's a snap from the stoppage. It's a goal out of nowhere. And Wybird celebrates accordingly.
A Perth father attacked in Northbridge has died.
A young soccer player fighting.
And a nice stoppage goal there. Maxi Tyres replay. Wybird just got a little bit of gap on his opponent. His deadly left foot kick, and he snapped truly there for the first goal of the last quarter.
And you can see there just a little bit of a funky handshake. What up, boys?
And Max's Tyres, the replay. They'll like to have a look at that. Hiscock gets another tap. I need more than that now. Bevan. Damati on the wing. Goes with the left. Marafiotti, a finger tipper. Just spent an almost grand final for him, unfortunately. And the ball wanders close to the boundary line.
He's had some hamstring issues in the past, Sav. And just reaching out for that one, I was a little bit nervous for him, but he's pulled up okay.
First goal of the last quarter to Peel. So they lead by 21. Central ball. Okay for Rance. What risks do they have to take here, West Perth? Sherwood kicked a brilliant goal in that last quarter. Terrific sidestep by Clark.
Brilliant, wasn't it?
Out of the danger.
Just composed. He didn't even do too much. Just knew where the two players were converging and headed in a different direction.
It just looked like they're playing the pace of the game well here.
Nah. All three of us picked Peel at three-quarter time, so I think it's done.
I can tell you more interested in the quaddy today than getting the result right in this one. Broadbent. Watch out. Orange, wow. Brilliant tackle. No prior, but there's a bit of mustard on that one. And still it's a live ball. And Peel have the Falcons exactly where they want them.
Right in front of the Peel bench there, and everyone was very animated. That's sort of the tackle that, again, you'll get some high fives on the replay when you watch that over at the end of the game.
Ball tossed back in. Broadbent, use of the body was legal, then lost his footing and might have hurt himself in the process. And Sherwood vigorous on Wearing.
Just a bit Sandy, that little patch there, maybe just lost his feet.
Contest this next stoppage, though.
Yeah, he's good as gold.
Wearing. Hand passes it forward. D'Amate, Garraway, Julian. Run supplied by Cabalza. And Bevan sends Alexander on a trek to the wing. Looking for Bevan. Uh-oh. He's got to be clean here. Spun out of trouble well enough. Wearing couldn't wrap him up. But Cabalza's gone.
The decision to go back in there, inboard there, Zave, I'm not sure if it was the right one. Keep the ball going forward.
It's a fine line, isn't it? He hits Bevan and away he goes. Said it's a bit sloppy and Peel get the chance. And here comes that left foot I like.
Wybird. No height there. Brought to ground. Not a bad result for Peel. And a snap is off target to the right-hand side.
Peel players take the team bus up today, or is it get your own way?
No, they caught the bus. I think even West Perth caught the bus as well.
Yes. And if they win now, they might get the train home a lot later.
Yeah. Ask mum and dad to chip in 20, get the bus driver waiting.
Yeah, the Uber driver. See if we can manage that. I wonder who did bring a change of clothes just in case.
Nah, always pack a spare kit, Skeet. It's 101 on grand final day.
Yeah, fair enough. Inside 50 ball. Tomasi, not quite. Carboni gets it from Clark. Across the face. Oh, ripping grab. Going down low. Wybird again. Tomasi. And they're playing the game on their terms. Finch darts his way through the middle. Wants to make the switch. It'll end up okay for Donaghy. He plays on. West Perth look out on their feet. Believe it or not, despite having the week's break. Funny how footy works sometimes, doesn't it? That ball's tied up. It'll be a ball up.
They're still keen to keep attacking, Peel. You see Donaghy play on there, send it inside 50. They really want to take this game out of any doubt and kick a few more goals.
Probably one goal away from feeling really, really safe. Sherwood, Bevan, Demandley was there to help out. Gets it back. Somehow found a way through, only just. In fact, no. The umpire said incorrect disposal.
Take your time getting this ball back now. I don't know. If it's not your kick, don't go get it. Would be the rule.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Ian Roberts, he's done, as a 16-year-old, done very well, played 9 games this year for the Colts as a 16-year-old.
How does that come about? You just, anyone can play, or you got to wait a certain time frame?
Generally, it might be after the State 16s program, and then they're back at their clubs for the remainder of the year, and the better ones are able to play up. And he's done really well, held his spot on the wing.
Well, inexplicably, Bevan, with 30 or 40 metres through the middle, guides it out wide. Taylor in turn for Alexander. Kicked a goal this afternoon, but really outside of Farrow, they haven't looked like having multiple options.
And they're missing big goals.
But here's Farrow on cue, off the outside of the boot. And somehow West Perth are still in this.
On the back to Tyre replay. There's long kick in. Got out the back and Noah Farrow opportunistically ran onto it and kicked a nice easy goal for his third for the game. 3-2.
Yeah, 3-2. Been a good day. Just starved an opportunity there for about 60 minutes. The ball just didn't come down enough and Peel dominated that patch. But for the win, he's probably going to have to jail another couple late in this game.
The only 17 points. I'm not going to just declare it just yet. Torrent to centre-half back. And get the next goal. Then we can start getting a little excited about what this last 10 minutes brings. D'Amate, pressure from Rush was good enough. Or was it? Yes, boundary throwing.
You mentioned, just I was about to mention before, that they're without one of their big goal scorers for the year, Jasper Scaife. He rolled his ankle at school a few weeks ago. And unfortunately,
at school?
Yeah, playing volleyball.
Okay.
And out for the season.
Yeah, kicked 20 goals, 13. So you're right, he would have been very handy today, and maybe he should be banned for playing volleyball anywhere if he's looking at football as a career. I say that in jest, as kleptic. Well, but what about pickup by Tregenza? Donaghy, this would be something. Left foot kick, top of the square. Will it be rushed? Oh, Logan. Tackle was great. No whistle. Play on is the call. And so West Perth able to escape, but only just. And Gathercole to the outer side. But what about that at ground level by Treginza?
I've mentioned it a few times. He's super at ground level.
Yeah. You know,
he's able to kick goals, like crumbing goals. And he's very dangerous. If you're a key defender, you've got to be on your toes all seconds of the game against him.
That breeze is certainly kicking up in the background there. That probably is favouring Peel Thunder.
I go inside again. Donaghy trying to make some ground. Doesn't quite get there. Knocked away by Taylor. Peel pressing. Donaghy on his hands and knees. Was intercepted by Taylor for West Perth. Here's Edwards at the 50. There's another big man in Broadbent. And that one didn't quite connect.
Mentioned Jasper Scaife out. Peel Thunder have got a national combine invitee out in Jed Adams, who on his debut league game dislocated his shoulder and had to have a shoulder reconstruction. It's a shame not to have him out there today.
Yes, one good turn deserves another, so the breeze is a factor. And if you're going to put it out from a Peel perspective, you may as well put it 10 rows back. And again, the seconds just keep rolling. To the 50. Finch off hands, looking lively. Treginza, here's his chance. 40 out, Finch. As we said, never ever going to give it off.
The blinkers are on. He's done it all day. Small forward. I'll tell you what, small forwards do a lot of the hard work for the big forwards who don't follow up a lot of the time that quickly. So, as we've noticed today, the ball's landed in his hands a few times and he's had the blinkers on.
It's a three-possession game, as they say. Three-goal differential. To Manly. Bit of room for Julian through the middle. If they can hit targets, should be a goal. You'd think. 60 out.
Julian's pushed
Farrow
forward.
Yep, that's good enough. And the mark taken by a goal kicker in Nelson. He turns quickly, goes to the pocket. And the defender, Luke Michael, gets his moment. The biggest kick of his year so far.
You're not wrong in, as a defender. Yeah, I'm not sure if you want your defenders having shots on goal.
What's he like?
He's a good mark, isn't he?
He's a beautiful mark.
Well, he can't mark it through the goals.
Maybe he needs to kick it to himself so he can get a bit closer.
But all serious,
I'm going to back him in.
This turns it into a 12-point game. If he kicks it, Michael to set them alight. Well, the Falcons are on the move in the Colts decider.
Overlap. Sees the defender, Luke Michael, and here it is. It was a bit like a defender's run-up. But it doesn't matter how they do it, as long as they go through. Skeet, they say they don't draw pictures in the paper. You just get your name in there. That's a good goal, very important.
Yeah, it doesn't matter whether you nick it through the slips for forward to bring up your century or not. It was a good kick, by the way. The breeze is fluky. This game is very much on a knife edge. 12-point margin. West Perth will be buoyed by that. Edwards goes in physically. Wybird and his teammate looked at each other momentarily. Looking for it. The ground level was Sprigg. Needless to say, next goal, if it's West Perth's, we are in for a ripping last 10 minutes. Taylor goes off the right, ill-directed. Look at that ball, that breeze. Dravitsky was almost nonplussed by it. Hand pass defensively, searching for Taylor. Taking a while to get hold of it. Was he leg? No, according to the umpire. Rance. Farrow dropped it in the tackle. Could have been penalised, was it?
Great tackle from young Roberts there. He managed to hold the ball in. You can see the willing at the contest. Well, might have been a trip there. I think he might have taken the leg.
Yeah, looked from our vantage point, a possible free. Tension rising here. Edwards with the launch. Wybird. And Tamati with a front-on tackle, ensuring that his opponent going absolutely nowhere in Roberts.
They're tired out there, but they're lifting. They're sensing the moment. Strong contest.
Sprigg, Edwards, how do you find a free kick out of this?
Peels.
Was Peels, you thought?
Yeah, West Perth slipped and then they both
brought it to ground. Wybird. What's a corridor ball now wearing? Alongside Taylor. Here's Finch. 60 out. He thought about it.
He thought about it.
But then went for home, essentially. Off hands, Tregenza to himself. Can he get off the ground? No. But I will say this. It's a handy behind.
Very handy. I've seen it all. Finch having shots from 80 now. Jeebies, I love him.
Were you ever in doubt that he was going to...
No, absolutely force? Not. But had to hold it long enough to pretend he was looking elsewhere. Here's a replay. Just a small margin in that.
Yep. Anyway, the turnover's occurred. Rush has taken it. He's outside range. He's going to hit the fat side. Ooh. Well, he does more than that. Might end up okay. Draper! Acrobatically, and he's
it's winded him.
Lost a bit of air out of the lungs in that contest. But what he can do here is take the oxygen out of West Perth's comeback with a straight kick.
Gee, that wind has, just looking at the trees in the background, Scoot, that has certainly picked up. So it's going to be a tough kick. I mean, that's ball inside 50. Didn't mean to hit Draper on the chest. Had 12 disposals and a goal today.
It's a handy player to slice it off the side of your boot towards.
Yeah.
You always have to play pretty well when you wear number 23 in any form of sport. This young man has embraced that. Can he embrace the moment? Oh, that ball has really taken off to the right.
Funnily enough, it's not the worst result out in the full. There's only one way to go, really, from here.
Soaks up 30 seconds in the process as well, so no time for meandering here. Demarty off to Skinder. Cannot afford a turnover here.
And you feel like we've seen a few today that have ended
in poorly.
Yeah.
Julian, it's a one-on-one. Out the back, gathered by Taylor. Half forward, Farrow was there, went past he and his opponent. Bryce, what will he produce? Farrow at ground level. Can they get it out the back door? Critical ball to be won here, and the umpire deemed it a stoppage. Gee, there was some space out the back. Yeah. West Perth had found a way through.
Great tackle, ball and all.
40 out.
Bevan's got to go towards goals. He's running towards the boundary line here away from goals. There's no option to get through the other side from where he's starting.
Broadbent and Farrow. No effective tap out of that. And as we tick to 18 and a half minutes, Peel by 13. Broadbent, a touch on it. Out the back, taken by Clark. Terrific mark. Wybird springs to his feet, gets it to Torrent. Wants to use the big man, Edwards. Watch out, ump. Edwards is shut down brilliantly by Taylor. Ball jars laterally. And Wybird, and Finch has it. And no questions what he's doing here.
I'll eat my hat if he passes, but Wybird started that play, took the fantastic mark on the halfback flank. And it was just here, a slight error, but gave himself time to catch up with the play. And there's that left foot. I've loved it all day. Bang, Finch.
Still a tough kick from this range and the breeze, which is doing some tricks at both ends of the ground.
One goal, two today. I think maybe one or two that hasn't quite registered.
Either way, he's using up 30 seconds here, which in the grand scheme of the grand final might be important. What's more important is the kick. And the small forward has just missed. It was on target for a long part of the journey.
Windy is certainly playing a huge part in this shot to goal. It's going to be difficult for anyone having a set shot for the remainder of this game.
Well gathered by Sherwood through the middle of that break. Clark, little volley to Bryce. Loose ball to be won here. Hacked out of there by Farrow.
Look at the numbers forward.
Marafiotti, no, the boundary line. And that allows Peel to get some numbers around the contest and start the countdown. Three goals kicked in this quarter. Let's say 27 minutes. They have to kick three in.
Seven.
Essentially, yes.
Can't see it happening, Skeet.
No.
But funny things have happened.
Wybird the tackle, Bevan the collect. Two Peel players vying for this. Inside defensive 50 to Marty, not able to snatch it on the way through. And West Perth having coughed up the grand final to Subiaco in the reserves by 6 points. Trail by 14, late in the piece in the Colts decider. Ball shuffled forward by Michael. was a fair effort, but Carboni's in the way and Torrent's the option. And surely now there's no need to push the button.
Torrent coming in for his 23rd disposals, two goals too. Been a huge day.
Head to the mic, Edwards' direction. Got hands to it briefly. Comes back to him, Klepsig. Inboard pass. Spiral by Broadbent. Ends up at about the 50. Gathercole will be first onto it. Wybird, wow, he has just been gallant. Almost forced the ball up. Yes, he did.
Going to be tough for best on ground.
Don't know, I think Torrent, 23 and two goals too.
Chewy has been very strong.
He's been very good.
Play Hall, very good at first half. Bevan's battled manfully all day.
It's Broadbent trying to control that ball, which got away from him. To Manly. Alexander. Did he hand pass it?
Yeah, he did.
Okay. To Manly again. Alexander cruising past. Under pressure. A real hit and hope hand pass. And Clark will just absorb the tackle, which is all he had to do. No prior.
All he had to do, but you've still got to be brave enough to grab that football. Your ribs are open and then cover yourself up and cop the tackle and not let it out. Good play.
When you've got a premiership medallion about 10 minutes away, these things, I suppose, are a little more attractive. Sprigg. Donaghy. Goes again. Chuia. And high contact on Sherwood. But there is no room for error here for West Perth. Just has to be corridor ball somewhere that's going to create some opportunities. Surging at the ball was demanding, not quite. And Peel knows it, West Perth knows it, and the West Perth faithful here, I think, have conceded it themselves.
Norton 2 today for West Perth, amended favourites in both.
It happened 2 years ago at Fremantle Oval, yeah. So that's not to say the trifecta will be repeated today. But Claremont's form, eerily ominous last week against the Sharks. Now coverage through until six tonight. Michael didn't get boots to ball. Broadbent was there. Sherwood taken by Damassi. Donaghy happy to force stoppage after stoppage.
You're going to have to say the decision for the three boys, Hall, Edwards and Logan, to give up the opportunity to play on grand final day is going to pay off in spades.
Absolutely vindicated. It's a terrific team ethos. And they'll have a premiership medallion around their neck. All things being equal, Bevan goes to ground. Sherwood scrapping hard. Off the deck goes Julian. Finally, the star mark broken. Wearing on the up. Davinsky slung. Clark almost collided with his teammate before getting it off the outside of his boot. Edwards, great defensive spoil. Sees a stoppage. And the Peel boys know they're home.
Very clever. Hit that 15-metre sideways, get it out of bounds. Take another 25, 30 seconds off the clock. Only a couple of minutes to go now.
They did finish second in the home and away season, so this isn't a mighty upset, but it's a mighty fine victory coming up.
Now, fantastic victory. They didn't have the big bodies around the football as such, but once it got out into space, gee, they were clean and fast and had the big keys up front too that ran and jumped at the footy.
No, absolutely. You just feel like the hot conditions might have played into that. Absolutely.
That being said, Peel have had the harder road to the grand final, so all credit for its due. Julian, they have been terrific. After conceding the first two goals, here's a mark for Farrow. 25 metres out. He'll go back as quickly and effectively as possible. Off a step, kicks the goal. He's got four. Lone hand in grand final. Lead of a oval.
What's been a big afternoon for Noah Farrow. Takes the easy chest mark, gets back very quickly off the mark, trying not to use up too much time and slots his fourth goal.
Just worth repeating, 25 minutes flat ordinarily, but in this grand final, yep, for each goal that is kicked during a quarter, there's a minute stoppage on that, correct?
That's correct.
So, we're guessing maybe a couple of minutes left for two goals, essentially. Edwards has taken a blow to the head. West Perth scrapping oh so hard to try and find a way forward. Not to be. They've turned it over. Torrent to left half forward. Klepsig. Up and down he went. Absorbing the contact is Draper. Now Klepsig lays the tackle. Got rid of Gathercole. He goes to ground. Wybird. Top of the square. Cleverly punched on to Galloway from Taylor. Oh, and lovely work out of defence. The kick was a little shaky. Fortunately, Bevan finds it. 27 minutes remain have gone. Galloway.
Got to find a foot.
Can they find a goal in a hurry? Siren can't be all that long away. Alexander back through the middle. Julian couldn't take it. They need to be clean. A kick wide. 60 out. Urge to go on. Inside 50. Well done by Clark. Attack the footy. Got it away from Sherwood. Look for the boundary line. The young man, two redheads going toe to toe. And the boundary umpire will be called into play.
What a play by Clark. Comes off his opponent, gets the spoil in. And not only that, manages to get it over the line and chew up precious time.
A bit of blood. A bit of a pause in play.
Mitch Edwards, the knocky cop to the head in the ruck contest. A little bit of blood coming from his face.
Disaster with about 20 seconds to go. You don't want to be sitting on the bench.
Well,
you want to be out there with your mates, and he's a good player too.
As long as you get the picture with the blood on the face.
Oh, to give it a bit of a reward for that.
Well,
Instagram profile picture or something.
Yeah, we're all told to enhance our profiles. Well, Peel's profile is going to be of a premiership team in just a few seconds, unless a miracle occurs. Julian, ball smothered. He spikes it forward. Crowd still doesn't know how long to go. Nor do we. Farrow, Garraway, Sherwood, oh. Take it high. Free kick, whistle. Well then, we're at 28:30.
He's a beautiful kick of the footy, Sherwood, but it is tough with this breeze pushing straight across right to left to goal.
Siren, not far away. Sherwood's kick is a goal. It's there. Or is it? Waiting for all clear. Goal umpire, surely, yes. The siren sounds. Peel of Premiers, dramatic victory. A goal on the siren. Falcons fall to the floor. Peel celebrate. An amazing win.
Well done. Look at the excitement. There's the kids. They're absolutely thrilled. We are the football is the game. We're all together. And winning is our aim. So cheer us on through the sun and rain. Cause thunder, thunder is our name. We are the thunder. And football is the game.
Peel Thunder win by 2 points. A dramatic conclusion to this one. Their first grand final triumph since 2005. Sherwood, a long bomb, but it was too little too late. Quite an extraordinary game with West Perth starting brilliantly. Peel dominating for the most part, but West Perth throwing as many shots without success at the end.
Yeah, two goals in 2 minutes. The first 2 minutes of the game. West Perth, and we sat up here and looked at each other and thought this could be a blowout. West Perth were on fire, and then credit to Peel Thunder. The next 40, 45 minutes was just their football. They had 13 scoring shots in a row. West Perth were on the ropes, but credit to the West Perth senior bigger bodies, then they got it going back on their terms. But I think the right team won on the day. I know it was only a two-point margin, but I think it's probably fair to say that the better team won.
No, absolutely. Both would have been deserving on the years that they've had, but today Peel with the better team for longer periods. So thoroughly deserved. the change in the time with the extra time added on after a goal added to the drama. Yeah. At the end there, we weren't too sure when it was going to finish, but a fantastic conclusion to the game.
Yes, Peel get the result, and Reece Tryant, 24 disposals, 2 goals next to his name as well. Fantastic effort, and Tyson Beattie is alongside him.
Yeah, one of the stars of this grand final. Reece, congratulations. You must be thrilled with the victory.
Yeah, I am. It was a great game. We've been super stoked of how we've been playing the last probably half of the season. Yeah, couldn't be prouder of the boys.
And West Perth threw everything at you in that last term, but you managed to hold on.
Yeah, I think our last halves over the year have been probably our best. We just seem to be able to push through and keep going at it, yeah.
Early on, West Perth had control and you fought your way back into the game, and you were really important with that. You must have been happy with the contribution you made today.
Oh, yeah, of course, but you know, it wouldn't happen without all the other boys out there. I just say I like cohesion through the mid and all that. We play pretty good together.
Reece, congratulations. Go and enjoy the celebrations.
Reece Tryant, a premiership player. They've beaten by 4 points in the second semi. They turn it around today, winning by 2 points in the end. Jordan McArdle has another premiership player alongside him.
Premiership player, premiership co-captain. Ethan, how does it feel?
Unbelievable. First ever grand final I've ever been in. So to get the win is pretty remarkable, especially with this group of boys.
And you were 24 points up at half-time. They came back hard, though, didn't they, in that second half?
Yeah, well, they're a great side. Like, I have to give it to them. Like, we worked our ass off, and I guess we deserve the win at the end of the day.
And some of those defensive efforts, you pride yourself on being a defensive player. How impressed with the efforts of guys like Tristan Bryce and Darcy Clark there in that last minute or so?
Yeah, no, unbelievable. They pretty much won us the game, I reckon, throughout the day. Just the little things I've done to just keep us in it as well. Like, yeah.
And scary thought, some of your better players were still bottom ages, so still another year of Colts, guys like Clay Hall, Reece Tryant, Mitch Edwards, Ethan Logan. It's pretty scary for next year as well, isn't it?
Yeah, oh well, they'll be back. We'll be back definitely next year, I reckon. Like, I have so much faith in those boys, and then even the other boys coming up, we could get a resi side in next year, or whatever happens.
All right, congratulations, Matt.
Thank you.
There it is, Jordan McArdle with Ethan Donaghy, 20 disposal today, co-captain, and enjoying the fruits of their very good labour today. As we said, 2 goals to start the match in the opening 2 minutes to West Perth, but after that it was 7-6, and then, well, the margin 2, extraordinary. Tyson Beattie, speaking of match winners and big boys, got Corey Tregenza alongside him.
Yeah, big Corey Tregenza. Corey, congratulations, a fantastic effort. Your tools were fantastic in the forward line today, and must have been a big difference today.
Yeah, credit to West Perth's back on, man. They are so good. But I think just the fact that we got the job done was the good part, you know. Everyone played their role, and just good team effort.
Hey, you're only playing country football not that long ago, and you've rocked up to Peel, and you've had a fantastic season. How much further do you want to take your footy from here?
Oh, definitely a lot further, man. I didn't expect any of this, but I'm just happy with the win right now. But, yeah, no, I'm not worried about that at the moment.
Corey, congratulations. Enjoy the celebrations.
Corey Tregenza, what a big player he has been for Peel this season. He kicked 5 in the preliminary final, kicked 1-2 today, but alongside some other key forwards, really made life tough for the Falcons. The Thunder are celebrating a victory in the Colts. It was the Lions in the reserves. And coming up shortly after the presentations, it's the big one. The league, the Falcons, the Tigers, don't go anywhere. It's all coming your way. 3:00 opening bounce. But next, it's a presentation for our Colts winners. That is the moment. Peel Thunder heard the siren, felt the joy, the elation, indescribable for these young men. With a goal from West Perth, trimming it to 2 points, there were fears they might have to withstand one final barrage, but the siren signalled a great moment for this footy club. 7:15 to 8:07. The margin 2 points, and not a bad way to keep this grand final weekend rolling.
Oh, fantastic. We've got another big game obviously coming up next, but when you're out in front too and you know that you're getting pegged back and you're getting pegged back and you can see the finish line but you don't know exactly when, it's a good grand final.
Absolutely. One grand final decided by 6, the second grand final by 2. It all sets a scene for a fantastic league grand final. But now let's head downstairs for the Colts presentation, and here's Tyson Beattie.
Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Peel Thunder on winning the 2022 Colts WAFL Grand Final. Please put your hands together for the players of both teams for this fantastic contest.
Congratulations to the umpires selected to officiate in today's WAFL Colts Grand Final. To present the Premiership medallions to the umpires, I would like to ask umpiring WA High Performance Boundary Umpire Coach Jeff O'Neill to present the umpiring medals to goal umpire Lachlan Bettini. We will now present the Mel Winnen Medal to the best player in the grand final as determined by the umpires. Mel is one of the legends of the WAFL and one of the greats for West Perth. We thank him for attending today's game and ask him to come forward to present the Mel Winnen Medal to the best player in today's grand final.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the medal for the best player in today's grand final is number 37 for Peel, Jackson Broadbent.
I'd like to thank West Perth. You know, you boys played really hard today. All the best for the next year and the years to come. Just really good spirit today, boys. To our boys, come on! How good is this, boys? I'll tell you what, from December last year to now, how good? Cheers.
Congratulations, Jackson, and thank you very much, Mel. I now invite Blair Bell to come forward and present the Premiership medallions to each player in the victorious team. Number one, Dominic Dravitsky. Number three, Taj Wyberg. Number four, Connor Carboni. Number five, Jackson Klepsig. Number seven, Byron Finch. Number eight, Dean Roberts. Number 12, Darcy Clark. Number 13, Joel Rush. Number 18, Will DeMarcy. Number 19, Ethan Logan. Number 20, Tristan Bryce. Number 21, Clay Hall. Number 23, Josh Draper. Number 24, Jai Martelli. Number 27, Matt Thompson. Number 30, Michael Selwood. Number 31, Reese Torrent. Number 33, Zane Waring. Number 37, Mitchell Edwards. Number 39, Jackson Broadbent. Number 40, Corey Tregenza. And now I invite the co-captains. Number two, Scott Tua. And number 17, Ethan Donaghy. Scott, if you'd like to say a few words.
I'll just reiterate what Brody said. West Perth, the premier comp of the side for pretty much the whole year, right from the start. We had a few close battles, and you know, today could have gone either way. So, well done to you blokes on a fantastic season. Our boys, well done. It's been a long, long climb out the mountain, hasn't it? We got there in the end, and it was a bit of a nail biter, but so proud of each and every one of you. And also thanks to the umpires and the WAFL for the day. So, cheers.
Would the coach of the winning team now, Danny Charters, come forward to receive his premiership medallion and say a few words? Put your hands together for Danny Charters, Colts winning coach.
Thank you very much. Firstly, again, to West Perth Football Club, to have all three grades playing the grand final this weekend is just goes to show that you guys are the benchmark of this comp. To Sass and your boys, I'll probably use the runners analogy for the majority of the year. You blokes are the front runners in front for a lot of the year, and we've got plenty of respect for you. Obviously, on a day like today, anything can happen, but that should take nothing away from your boys' season. You play a really great style of football, and unfortunately, one team has to lose. But I guess for you boys, I know today probably won't be a happy time, but hopefully you can reflect back on the season, and hopefully majority of the positives comes out of it. So thank you very much, West Perth. I'd like to thank the umpires and the WAFL for putting on days like this. Obviously, the game doesn't happen without the umpires, so they're super important to the development of our game. And then also the WAFL for getting Leadable Oval up to scratch for today for us to play on. And, you know, just to have the setup that we have today is excellent. And Channel 7 being able to showcase our great youth game. So to obviously the WAFL, Channel 7 and our umpires say, well done to you blokes. And then I guess I look over this side and we talk about the journey up the mountain, and I couldn't be prouder for the bunch of blokes. You know, we had 1,000 feet today. We travelled 11,000 total, but you sort of stand at the top, and I think looking back, I've enjoyed every single minute. So, you know, while this is what we get for it today, I appreciate every single one of you that's on this side of the field. You've all played your role in getting us here today, and I think the sad part is that I was probably closer to playing in the last Colts flag, but I'm extremely privileged to coach this group of young men, and this is something that you can live with for the rest of your lives and be able to share with one another. So for me to do that with such a great group of people, I'm super appreciative. I love you all, and thank you very much.
Thanks, Denny. I now invite Blair Bell to present the Premiership Cup to the captain and coach. Put your hands together for Peel Thunder, Colts Premiers 2022.
So Peel Thunder, Premiers for 2022, a dramatic 2-point victory over West Perth. They lead by 24 points at half time, and they get home in an absolute thriller. A goal to Sherwood in the dying seconds brought that margin within a kick. The full-time siren rang. West Perth players fell to the floor. And, of course, Peel Thunder players delighted with that result. It ends an amazing season of footy in the Colts. Some of the best young talent in Western Australia and Australia. And the Thunder tonight celebrating a success. Their first since 2005. Of course, all roads lead to the 3 o'clock bounce down in the league between West Perth and Claremont. Coming your way shortly here from Leaderville Oval. All the build-up, all the excitement from Footyville and here at Leaderville Oval up next.